alright? If you're going with lights, be out here in the streets, you know, play some concourse. Another Saturday. First and foremost, we'll give all praises to Yahweh.
I will worship Yahushai, worship Kakadash.
Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 20. And in those days, and in that time, saith the Lord, the iniquity of Israel shall be sought for, and there shall be none, and the sins of Judah, and they shall not be found. For I will pardon them whom I reserve.
Ooh. Whom he reserves. Who are the men that he reserves, man? His elect. There are 7,000 that didn't bow down to Baal, man. You know, so hopefully, you know, Lord will pardon that number. We want to make it, man. We want to be hid in that day of trouble, man. Spoken about to well, spoken about Daniel. You know, a day that's never been before, never been again. That's why we sacrifice our lives, coming out here to this truth, man. Dealing with these elements, dealing with these demons, you know, bearing our cross out here.
Isaiah 55 and 7, let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts.
Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let's talk about Israel, man. Because I'm talking about the actual wicked. Let's talk about the wicked of our people, man. You have to forsake your way. How do you forsake your way, man? By taking heed to this word. As it's spoken about in the book of Psalms. Going back to your nationality. Going back to your power. And going back to the name, Jehovah, the son of Yahushai, man. Worshiping those names, praying those names. People are lost catching these names to the best of your ability. That's how the wicked, two-thirds of our people, forsake the way, but they're not going to do that. They're not going to repent.
It says, and let him return unto the Lord, Yahweh, while Yahweh shy, and he will have mercy upon him.
He will have mercy upon him. You know, but you have to return, you have to be born again. You know, but two-thirds of our people don't want to do that. Man. I mean, that's okay, man. It's not for them, all right?
And repentance is not for everyone. So John the Baptist said, and so what the scribes, the Pharisees says, who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bring therefore fruit, meat for repentance. It shows you that everyone is not meant to repent in this time. The only one that's going to get right and repent is the elect.
That's right. The Lord saved everyone back out of Egypt. That's what happened. And the Lord will, we've got to get to that. That in Exodus 32.
And that's where that scripture says, not willing that any should perish, but all should come to.
You gotta speak up, brother.
That's why the scripture says, not willing that any should perish, but all to come to life.
Repentance.
To repentance, Slakia. Because the elect, man, Yahabai Shimon Shah is only gonna have mercy on the elect.
The elect. That's what it's all about at the end of the day, man.
Right, that's why it's, you know, one of the prophecies what? The elect being sealed. You know?
That's why it's important to come out here and do this work, man. Because all it takes is for the elect to hear this word, man. And then instantly they're sealed. And once they're sealed up, that's when the Lord's going to come back, man. That's when that destruction's going to come.
I got it. Let me finish this.
It says, let him return unto the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, and he will have mercy upon him and to our power, for he will abundantly pardon.
Pardon, man. But there's going to be pardon out here. That's the term that the government used, you know, when the president, when he pardons a certain prisoner out of prison, he needs to forgive, man. So you want to be pardoned for these last days, man. So you want to adore until the end. Your will, you know, you'll be saved. all about, man. Last week we went into the helmet of the salvation. Gotta constantly think about that salvation. Dealing with your infirmities. You know, dealing with persecutions. You know, dealing with conviction, whatever it is you're going through, man. Bearing that cross. Pushing to another day, man.
Dealing with these demons, man.
Demons, yeah.
Okay? Because in these days and time, man, demons are gonna come, you know? Yesterday I walked into the store. The time when I walked into the store, this black lady, old lady, she had little short hair like that, alopecia, dyed blonde, and when I walked in, she's like, what are you doing in here? You know what I'm saying? And just kept messing with me the whole way till the manager had to come up and say, what are you messing with this man for? You don't even know him. You know? Just demons, man.
That's why she's cursed.
Right.
That's why she's cursed. That's why, you know, kept the hell that you fought having to deal with that bitch.
Right.
So we're all under this person. That's why the bitch ain't had no hair.
Exactly. You know?
That's why she's a demon, man. She's a demon now, she's a demon in her past life.
Chapter 17, verse 24. But unto them that repent, he granted them return, and comforted those that failed in patience. Return unto the Lord, and forsake thy sins, and make thy prayer before his face, and offend less. Turn again to the Most High, and turn away from iniquity, for he will lead thee out of darkness into the light of health. And hate thou abomination vehemently.
Set up, hate thou abomination vehemently. You gotta hate the wickedness of this place, man, and separate yourself from the world. Can you read that again from the top?
Sirach 17 to 24. But unto them that repent, he granted them return, and comforted those that failed in patience.
Man, comforted those that failed in patience, man. Lord will our patience be failed. This time. Yeah, this is that comfort. You know, scriptures, repentance, return. Return what? Return of our nationality. Ultimately, return to our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, man. That husband, marriage.
Return unto the Lord and forsake thy sins, and make thy prayer before his face.
Make thy prayer before his face. You know, we have to return to the Lord and extend his names, and know the names, in order to pray. Pray properly. Yahweh would actually hear your prayers, man. Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai? These names are very important, man.
And offend less.
Offend less. You know?
Yeah, it says, let not your sins weigh you down, and your iniquities let them themselves.
And don't let your sins weigh you down. That's what we always say. You know, keep the laws to the best of your ability.
Yeah.
You're gonna go off. Right?
We're not perfect.
That's right.
Never gonna be perfect in this flesh. We won't be perfect when Yahweh Shai changes us.
That's right. We can get into that. That's what all Israel's gonna receive.
So Micah 7 and 18. Who is a God like unto thee that pardoneth iniquity and passeth by the transgression of the remnant of his heritage? He retaineth not his anger forever, because he delighteth in mercy. He will turn again, he will have compassion upon us, he will subdue our iniquities, and thou wilt cast all their sins into the depths of the sea.
Yeah. That's the day that we're looking for, to cast all of our sins into the depths of the sea. Have that mercy. He says that he loved mercy, man. That's why you gotta have mercy.
Yeah. He delighted for mercy.
He delighted for mercy. You have to delight in mercy. Yeah. Have mercy for a brother, man.
That's right.
When the brother goes off, man, have mercy on that brother, man. The spirit will go to the brother.
That's right, huh? That's the right spirit to be in, man. Be merciful. That should be a natural thing for a believer. Just being merciful, man. You know, that's with your woman, with your children, with brothers, with just people, man.
Yeah.
You're just a merciful person.
But Esau is not going to get any mercy. Why? Because he has shown no mercy.
That's
part of it, man. Yahweh Shai showed mercy.
That's why the scripture said, if you hate your brother, you're like Cain, you know, a murderer, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because here it is, that spirit ain't in Esau.
it don't have no compassion upon no one. So if you can't have no compassion upon your brother, how you call yourself a servant of the Lord?
Right.
You're not. You're a murderer, man.
Yeah. The
scripture says, forbear them that are weak. Forbearing somebody is pretty much being merciful.
Being long-suffering.
Yeah.
You got to speak up, brother. Camera right over there.
So like I said, the scripture said, forbear one another. Or forbear them that are weak. To forbear somebody is to be merciful to that person.
Yeah. Merciful. Forgiving. You want to be forgiven, so you can't forgive someone else.
Oh, that's that parable.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh. Can I get
it?
Bring it up. This is Sirach, chapter 2, verse 18. Saying, we will fall into the hands of the Lord, and not into the hands of men. For as his majesty is, so is his mercy.
Yeah. We're going to fall into the hands of the Lord. But we don't bear things about you. Men will let you down, man. You're going to fall into the hands of men.
Especially the wicked one.
Especially the wicked one.
Yeah, as his majesty is, so is his mercy, man. We can't comprehend his majesty. You know? We barely could understand the things that are on this planet.
Right.
How can we begin to understand the majesty of the Most High? You can't.
Yeah.
So we can't begin to understand His mercy.
Yeah, no. Like with King David, he committed adultery, committed
murder.
He numbered Israel, and all those sins were worthy unto death. But the Lord had mercy on him. He didn't put him to death. Sure. Like the scripture says, the mercies of David.
Sure, mercies of David. Yep.
Yeah. Hey, yeah. Can you go back to that Isaiah 5:8, just what the scripture saying, that we can't comprehend the grace of the Most High, the mercies of
Him. Yeah. Isaiah 55:8, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai. For as heaven is higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts.
That's right, so you know, we can't really comprehend ways to the Most High, the situation that the Most High puts us in. You say, hey, whatever it is, be merciful, you know? Be forgiving, be loving, you know?
Hey, the heaven being higher than the earth is infinite, okay?
Well, yeah, we don't know how
it's endless.
You don't know that limit there, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, same thing with how deep the ocean is.
Right. Yeah, the heavens, man. Esau will break it down a little bit. You know, watch his little videos on different planets, how big certain stars are compared to our stars. You don't know. Esau don't know at the end of the day.
Right.
I got a quick piece of it. Romans chapter 9, verse 15. For he saith to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion.
That's funny, because that's King David, right?
Right.
Just talking about Moses.
Hey.
Yeah. Oh, mercy.
Hey, the Lord, he could choose to have mercy on you, or he could choose not to have mercy on you.
See, but it goes back to the elect.
Right.
The Lord knows who's who.
That's right.
You know? King David didn't necessarily know who he was. You know, things developed, things unfolded.
Right, yeah.
You know? Same thing with Moses. Things unfolded. Same thing with us.
Yeah.
You know, we're hopeful elect, but we didn't know that we would have this opportunity.
Right.
But we know now that
It's
predestinated. Everything's already preordained. So when you understand that, the Lord's having mercy upon the same souls.
Right.
Throughout these same generations.
You don't know who we are. That's the scary part. All we can do is show diligence. We need more to the best of our ability. Keep pushing.
That's all we got.
Yeah, you know, mercy on him. He has mercy. Nothing we can do about it.
Hey, but you got the Arkansas. But I think that they can just do as they please. And the Lord, oh, he's a merciful God. He will forgive me. Nah, man. Because the Lord knows your heart. When you repent, he knows if it's sincere or not.
Yeah, when the Lord will heal people, he will say, go and sin no more.
Mm-hmm.
So So you can't ask for forgiveness for something and then continue in it. You have to change your ways, your behavior, yeah. your habits. You have to leave off from certain things. All right?
And the Lord healed people in accordance to their own belief. Okay?
Right. Faith has made
me whole.
And that's why the Lord was pissed off at us back in the day, you know, because we were sincere about forgiving. Back, you know, when we were like incense, like on the altars.
Yeah.
You know, it was a turtle dove or bullock. Innocent, they knew that they were gonna do it. But they had that offering right there. Wait,
that's premeditated sin.
Exactly.
You know, I'ma do this, but I got a nice lamb that I've been saving up just right. for this sin.
You've already sinned before you even did the sin. Once you've said, once you got that turtle dove for that sin, you've already sinned right there.
Right.
Okay.
It's further going into you know, having that mercy, that forgiveness, man, you know, and also following the law as well. This is Romans chapter 13, verse 8. It says, owe no man anything but to love one another. For he that loveth another hath fulfilled the law. For this, thou shalt not commit adultery, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness, thou shalt not covet, and if there be any other commandment, it briefly comprehended in his saying, namely, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. So it's all about treating others how you would want to treat yourself, man. All right, you know, sometimes, you know, it's putting a brother first, all right? It says, love worketh no ill to his neighbor, therefore love is the fulfilling of the law. You know, meaning, you know, don't have any, you know, grudge, don't think negatively towards any brother, man. All right, like it says, like Apostle Paul just quoted, man, love worketh no ill towards, you know, a neighbor, man, your brother. All right?
Good example, you know, of grace. The scriptures tell you that Yahweh Shai, he brought grace, right? So John 8, 1, Yahweh Shai went unto the Mount of Olives, and early in the morning he came again into the temple, and all the people came unto him, and he sat down and taught them. And the scribes and the Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery. When they had set her in the midst, they say unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what sayest thou? Which is right, right? That's the law in the scriptures. That woman is to be put to death. That man is to be put to death. This said they, tempting him, that they might have to accuse him, right? Yahweh Shai knowing their thoughts. He knew their intentions, man. You know? It says, but Yahweh Shai stooped down and with his finger wrote on the ground as though he heard them not. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up himself and said unto them, he that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone at her. So you right. Be right in your judgment, right? But whoever is without sin, go ahead, you know, get it started.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Be making a point.
That's right.
It says, and they which heard it, Salah. And again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. And they which heard it, being convicted by their own conscience, went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even unto the last, you know, which we, through extrapolation, you know, you could say that Yahweh Shai was writing down their sins. Okay? It says, and they which heard it, being convicted by their own conscience, went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even unto the last, and Yahweh Shai was left alone, and the woman standing in the midst. When Yahweh Shai had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, woman, where are those thine accusers? Hath no man condemned thee? She said, no man, Lord. And Yahweh Shai said unto her, neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more.
That's right.
So that's a great, you know, a great example, a great thing that Yahweh Shai was doing right there, you know, making a point, you know, of that mercy and that grace that Yahweh Shai brought. You know?
The Father Yahweh gave all the authority to the Son Yahweh Shai, the power to be able to forgive sins.
Right. So you always want to humble yourself, man. You see a brother going off, not doing the right thing or whatever, you got to be more humble in that particular situation. Somebody get Galatians 6:1.
Yeah, because I can imagine, like the brother was saying, the Lord right near sins now. You're gonna need mercy for your own sins.
Yeah, by name, probably. Like,
okay, yep.
By name, you did this 2 days ago.
No.
You were just committing adultery this morning.
Right. Exactly. You know?
Hey, they were looking to condemn her.
And they were tempting Yahushua.
But they themselves got condemned for their in their mind, because they must have did something great to leave her alone, to not put her together.
Man. They're being hypocrites.
Galatians chapter 6, verse 1 says, "Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such as what? In the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted."
That's right, man. So you see a brother going off, man, you got to guide that brother to the right path, man. Let him know what he's doing. You got to rebuke him, you know, and let him know. Through all meekness and humbleness, man.
Hey, like,
lest the saintly jump on you.
Like Peter. It wasn't necessarily Peter, it was Satan that was messing with Peter, man. And Lord rebuked Peter, you know?
Well, Peter was coming, because Yahushua knew what he had to come and do. He had to be that sacrifice. And Peter was telling me, nah, you're not, you ain't gonna die. And that sounded like Satan. You know, that's feeding into that, to Yahushua's flesh. You know, he don't want to go on that cross, but hey, nah, get behind me, Satan.
Right.
I came here to do what I gotta do.
Right. He came to do the will of the Lord.
Right.
You know, not his own
like,
will.
Like a brother said, bro, you ain't gotta go to the iron station.
Oh, right.
Yes, yeah. I do. What you talking about?
We all do.
That's right. But yeah, I got that same scripture in the NLT. It's, your brothers and sisters, if any other believer is overcome by some sin, you who are godly should gently and humbly help that person back onto the right path, and be careful not to fall into the same temptation yourself.
Right?
Yeah, man.
It's something we gotta learn how to do all over again, man. How to be brothers, how to be merciful. Which really, man, you should have already been a merciful person. You should have already had been a man of integrity. You should have, you know?
Israelites.
Yeah. You know, naturally.
Part of
not necessarily Israelites, but, you know, the hopeful elect had these attributes about them already.
Yeah.
You know, like humility. You either humble or you're not. Before the truth, you know?
You had some type of respect about you.
You know what I'm saying?
Respect other people.
Well, you character.
You're just a nigga.
Yeah. You already had that in you. It's got to be drawn out of you, really.
Right.
Micah chapter 7, verses 18. Who is a God like unto thee that that pardoneth iniquity and passeth by the transgressions of the remnant of his heritage? He retaineth not his anger forever, because he delighteth in mercy.
Sorry. The Lord is not going to be angry forever, man. Punishment's almost up. All Israel is eventually going to be saved out of
here. Right.
Yeah, let's get to that new covenant. Jeremiah 31.
Hebrews 8:6-2.
Speak up, brothers.
Verse 19, and it says, "He will turn again. He will have compassion upon us. He will subdue our iniquity, and thou will cast all your sins depth of the sea. Thou will perform the truth to Jacob and the mercy to Abraham, which thou hast sworn unto our fathers from the days of old."
Yeah, you know, that's what we're looking for, to cast our sins in the depths of the sea. Because we don't know what we did in our past lives, man. We know sins that we did in this life. We don't know what we did in our past lives, man.
Right.
All we can hope is that part of that hope is left, man.
You can't say that you're not without sin either. You know, you got groups out here talking about they don't do sin. They're without sin. Okay? And all
no
of
man
us,
without sin.
Yeah, all of us with sin, man. Okay?
Probably all lined up, faded up, shit to my name without sin. No beard on their face.
Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
This flesh is selfish. Feeling this flesh. This flesh inherently just wants to do the opposite of what the Lord wants.
Oh, yeah. This world is contrary to the scriptures.
Well, everything. Slot, brother. The scripture said that the creature was made subject to vanity. Okay, the Most High made us go off like that so we would have to seek Him. Okay? It's a process.
Yeah.
Okay?
We don't know how to save us. We
exactly.
can't save ourselves.
Right.
By keeping the law.
Nor did He want us to be able to be justified by this flesh.
Right.
You know, everyone has to go to Yahweh Shai.
Right.
You justified by your faith in Yahweh Shai. Fuck your works. You know? Even Paul, he was like, if anybody could boast in the fleshly things, it's me. But he counted all that dung for the knowledge of Yahweh Shai.
Hey, that's why brother brought it out earlier. His ways are higher than ours.
Yeah.
Because he's not looking on the outward part. Like, he's looking at your spirit, man, and the faith in you. Instead of like the flesh and what you're doing, keeping the commandments and stuff like that.
Right.
And the Lord looking at your spirit. That's beautiful.
Yeah. Trade a triple off. You ain't gonna get this. Look at the sin. You gotta go to bed. You don't let your sins weigh you down.
That's what makes it a fight.
A fight. Constant battle. Constant battle.
I have this real quick, man. Brothers are going into separating yourself from the world. This is Romans 12 and 2. It says, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of the Lord.
By the renewing of your mind, that's how you get born again. That's the real baptism. I'm being dumped in water, in the changing of your mind, the renewing of your spirit. You know? That's how you become born again. Your whole change, your whole outlook on things, not conforming to this world. Separating yourself from this world. Spiritually.
Ecclesiastes 7 and 20. For there is not a just man upon earth that doeth good and sinneth not.
Right. Oh, yeah. There is no just man. No. Come
on. So everyone sins.
Yeah.
Ain't no way around it. You know? That's why Paul said it. It's not me that sinned, but it's the flesh.
Right.
Flesh, right?
Yeah, Shai said, you know, the spirit is one, but the flesh is weak. You know?
The only difference between us and the world, we fight against sin. We don't willfully sin, you know? Even though we go off, we don't willfully sin.
Yeah, we're not wicked. The scriptures say there's no condemnation to them that are in Yahweh Shai. Because here it is, we go off, but in the spirit, hey, we pure, man. In the spirit, man. We wanna, if it was up to us, we wouldn't sin. Come on, man. But it ain't up to us.
Yeah.
Why do you think we earnestly cried to Yahweh Shai to come and get us? To take us out of this flesh. So we could be on point, man. That's one of my strongest desires. I want to be perfect, man. I want to be perfect, man. I don't want to have no bad thoughts. You know?
Yeah.
Make a mistake and shit.
Right.
Say the wrong thing and shit all the damn time.
Yeah.
I hate that shit, man. I said the wrong thing. Like, goddamn, why did I say that, man?
Right.
Or why did I say it like that? Or, you know, it's like, goddamn, that's why it's perfect, man. You know?
You have people that go off, but they don't even know it's sin.
Yeah.
Like, eating, like, the dietary laws.
Our lineups, bro.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. That's not something that people tell you in the world. Getting your hair lined up?
Right, right.
Or your beard. Shaving off your beard. That's something normal to this world, right?
Yeah,
Shaving off your beard, that's something normal to this world.
Yeah,
they don't know that's against the scriptures. And that's a law that's like it. That's a law that we could keep.
Yeah. Are men submitting themselves to women? That's a big thing.
Oh, yeah.
You going off.
Need a dietary law. It's easy with the dietary law not to. It's easy not to eat pork and shrimp and lobster.
Yeah, but that's something that Jake is aware of in the world.
Right.
They know they shouldn't be eating that shit.
Right. Yeah.
They know. That's something I heard growing up.
Yeah.
You ain't supposed to eat pork and shrimp, and I never had none of that shit, man.
Testimony.
Yep.
When I was like 5-6 years old, my grandparents gave me catfish. I grew up, eyes swole, the whole nine, I could barely see. I never touched the stuff ever again. Wow. I ain't touched seafood until I was like maybe in my 20s.
Me too, bro.
You know what I'm saying? And then I was like, oh, it's not too bad. I ain't gonna die.
Yeah, that's what happened to me when I was a kid. I had ordered this pizza, put ham on it. This ham and the pizza, I eat it, I got sick as fuck. Growing up, never had ham on pizza ever again after
that
day. Wow. It was like, hey, yeah, you know? Little bacon joints?
Bacon,
yeah.
Little bacon joints.
Yeah.
They got allergic
reaction.
Whatever, I got 6
health. Yeah, bro, I didn't start eating seafood until I read that y'all was trying to eat fish and all of that.
What?
I never had crab, lobster, shrimp.
I got to force, back in the day, I had to force myself to eat that stuff, like, shrimp, like, oh, I think I like it, only fried, you know what I mean? And then, I was like, how do you guys eat crab legs? How do you do that? Yeah. Like, they would eat them, like, oh, you know?
Oh, I was always disgusted by it.
Yeah.
Same, it's already in your spirit, like, yeah. You're disgusted. You know, I personally don't like my food all chewy like that. But that's
Oh, what are you talking about?
Like shrimp.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just like the raw meat. That's Jake knows.
Oh, man.
You know, that's every Jake spirit.
That's crazy, man.
Steak tartare. Anybody, you know Jake's
right. That, man. That's one thing that Jake got right, man.
Yeah.
Well done, you know, well done.
Jake, that goes back to, you know, the renewing of your mind. You know, when you sin, you understand sin. You understand the word. You understand the truth. You know? That's the renewing of your mind. That's being born again. That's the Jake, you put on. 100%, you understand it.
Right. Now you got a measure. Now you got something to judge things off of. A
metric.
Yeah, there you go. Because before, what are you going off of? Your fucking, you know, things that you were inserted into you while you were growing up.
Yeah.
You know, things that you just feel that are right or, you know, wrong, you know?
They call it intuition, but really...
I mean, kind of intuition, but really it's...
A gut feeling.
Yeah.
When you have the scriptures, you know exactly what it is.
And if anyone want to speak against it, hey, you can go right to the scripture. You know?
I got something that goes together.
So finish. I just had a question. It's the book of 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 16. You know, brothers were going into how, you know, not willfully, you know, sinning, man. You know, not going out of your way like the rest of our people, man. All right? It says, as free and not using your liberty for a cloak of maliciousness, but as the servants of the Lord. So not using the grace, you know, that we've been given by Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, you know, as an event, you know, to go off, man. All right, to be wicked, man. All right, like the Apostle Paul said, man, you know, we're still under the law, man. You know, we still follow what's written in it. All right, we don't keep, we can't keep it 100%, you know, this captivity. But, hey, we do keep it the best that we can.
All right. Rehearse the righteous acts.
Yeah. See, that's how people continue to go off because they know what is in the law, right? But they say, we're not under the law right now. Okay, we're under grace. So it's okay for me to eat pork and shrimp.
Talk about who? They learned that from the devil.
Exactly.
That was a trick from the devil. That's crazy, but then they still collect tithes.
Right, exactly.
They always, Jake always talking about it's the Lord's Day, but aren't you referring to the Sabbath? You know? Isn't that all in the law? Remember the Sabbath? Keep it holy? So Jake is just confused, man.
Yeah.
You don't know your ass from your elbow, man.
Jake just want to go off. Jake want to sin. Okay? Being righteous to them is some, oh, I can't do this or I can't do that. You know, how people come up and say, yeah, y'all have me up until y'all said I can't eat pork no more. Okay? We have people come up there and say that to us, man.
Yeah. the reason why the pork is the cheapest meat.
Right. Exactly. You got pork in there under $1 a pound. Okay? And beef in there like $8 and $7.99 a pound.
Or you can eat chicken, nigga.
Exactly.
Yeah. How about that? Chicken is still fire.
Right. Man, I had it all last week.
Chicken?
Yeah.
Cheapest thing on the block.
I got to eat some chicken.
I got to put something.
That's like, you know, that's the Christian church. It's their grace. It's cloaked maliciousness.
Yeah.
We're the grace. Yeah, I can do that.
Rock 15 and 20.
Hey, so I get, bro. So how do you repent?
They don't.
You want the grace and you can do whatever you want. How do you repent, man? What are you turning away from?
Right.
There's no repentance in the Christian church. Come as you are.
Come as you are.
You can be a fucking faggot.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I bet you if you go to church now, there's trannies next to you and shit.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
These women are fucking whores. Nobody's rebuking nobody, man.
They made up that shit. They reversed it. He said that the Lord hates the sin and not the sinner. Okay? When the scripture says totally the opposite, man.
That makes sense.
Okay?
Like the Bible says, come as you are. You're supposed to change when you repent.
Right, right. It's a new creature, right?
Right.
Yeah. They also changed the laying with man as you lay with mankind. They say it's a child.
But
it's okay to lay with man. They say that it's okay to lay with a man. As you lay with mankind, they changed it to say it's laying with a child.
Mm.
You're not allowed to lay with a child, not a man. A man can lay with another man. That's what they changed it up to in church.
That even take it with the scriptures.
Right.
We did that.
Hey. You know
who
did that.
Yeah.
The damn pedophiles did that one.
Definitely. This is Sirach 15 and 19. And his eyes are upon them that fear him, and he knoweth every work of man. He hath commanded no man to do wickedly,
man.
Neither hath he given any man license to sin.
Right, license is permission, right? You have a driver's license.
Yeah.
You have permission from the government to drive a vehicle. The Lord never gave anyone permission to go off to sin. And then, what is sin? Jake don't even know what sin is. Sin is the breaking of the Most High's law. So if you can sin, that means the Lord's law is still in effect. So the Lord didn't give nobody license to sin. So get the freak out of here with that madness, man.
Well, yeah.
The scripture said the Lord hated sinners, man.
Yeah.
You can't get around that.
God loves the sinner.
But why does the scripture say he hates sinners?
That's what they say.
You're keeping up the law of the Most High. That's your relationship with the Most High. That's how you walk with him. By walking in his statutes, his laws, his commandments, man.
Most importantly, in faith. You're doing all of that in faith.
I actually, the name of it's in the back here, so I usually run.
I got one, man.
I forgot my sword today.
It's Psalms 5.
You have all this diversity here.
And 4.
Maybe if we talk.
It says, for thou art not a God that hath pleasure in wickedness, neither shall evil dwell with thee. The foolish shall not stand in thy sight. Thou hatest all workers of iniquity.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
God doesn't hate. Who hates, man?
He said, thou hatest all workers of iniquity. That's the book of Psalms. Jake loves me, Psalm 23.
Yeah.
Well, jump your ass to Psalm 5 and read that. Let me see what the NLT says. It says, therefore, the proud may not stand in your presence, for you hate all who do evil.
Yeah. So
hate the evil. Love the good, right? Come on, man. It's all linking up, man.
Yeah, I got a quick one. It's Sirach 12 and 6, for the Most High hated sinners.
See?
There he goes again. Hated. The Lord hates. The Lord's a man of war. The Lord is all that.
Right?
And will repay vengeance unto the ungodly and keep them against the mighty day of their punishment.
Man, the mighty day of their punishment. We'll get vengeance. How is he going to do that? He's going to be the missiles, man.
Right. So I'm sorry. It makes sense that the Lord hate Esau, right? Because he's the man of sin.
Yep.
If the Lord hates sinners, of course he's going to hate Esau. because he's the man of sin. You know? So you Christian church, that's why hey, a lot of Jake's leaving that church, man.
Yeah.
A lot of Jake's leaving the church.
Wait, the Lord does what he wants to do. Now, first time, he has mercy on him, he really wants to. He drains this devil for the dare of evil, man. And he hates him at the same time. Yeah. Hey, that's what it is, man.
Sirach chapter 34:19. The Most High is not pleased with the offerings of the wicked, neither is he pacified for sin by the multitude of sacrifices.
That's pretty good.
Read again.
He says, the Most High is not pleased with the offering of the wicked, neither is he pacified for sin by the multitude of sacrifices.
So even in ancient times, our people, when they were offering sacrifices to the Lord, he knew that they were doing it wickedly, you know, and he's not pleased with the offering of wickedness, man. You know, you can't pacify Yah by Shimon Shai, man.
You can tell these are ham. At least they look like ham.
All right. Hey,
how you going, man? Now you good, brother? You good?
I'm sorry.
It's all right. Yeah. Could be Jake though, could be.
Yeah.
How you doing, man?
I'm fine, fine.
Let's go.
There's gonna come a day, you know, where all Israel's gonna be saved, man. It's gonna change us all from the inside, man. It's gonna change that stony heart, the fleshy heart, so we never go off of it. Alright, so let's get that Jeremiah 34.
Anybody got that? 31? Hold on,
Jeremiah chapter 31 and verse 31. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel. And with the house of Judah.
With the house of Israel and the house of Judah. I thought it was the whole world.
Yeah, hey. That's right. No. Just with Israel. Israelites. So it's always been about that.
Go ahead.
And this is end days prophecies because in the little the header, when you first go to the chapter, it says, in the last days Israel be gathered and the Lord declares that Ephraim has a birthright as the first point. But it's dealing with end times, man. And it says verse 31, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah, not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day that I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, which my covenant they break, although I was an husbandman unto them.
So the Lord, though he saved all Israel, going out of Egypt, man. Saved all of us. What did we do? You know? We totally went off, man. Did all types of wickedness, man. All the miracles that we saw still went off. Still didn't have faith. You can read about that account with that Exodus 32.
You guys all get in front of me.
Exodus 32.
Hold on.
You have it?
Exodus chapter 32,
at
1, it says, and when the people saw that Moses delayed to come down out of the mount,
so this is when we were in the wilderness and Moses went up to Mount Sinai, right after we just, rescued, delivered, out of Pharaoh. Go ahead.
It says, the people gathered themselves together unto Aaron and said unto him, up, make us gods which shall go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we would not what is become of him.
No faith, bro.
Yep.
No faith. Did not he go up there to meet with Yahweh Shema Shai? What do you mean? What are you talking about?
It says, and Aaron said unto them, break off the golden earrings which are in the ears of your wives, of your sons, and of your daughters, and bring them unto me.
That was Aaron. You know? It was Moses' brother doing that.
Caused him to go off. Man. Caused him not to go into the promised land.
Crazy. After all they saw, man. Splitting of the sea. All that, man.
Even the plagues.
Plagues, yeah. All.
It says that all the people break off the golden earrings which were in their ears and brought them unto Aaron. And he received them at their hand and fashioned it with a graving tool. After he had made it into a molten calf, and they said, this be thy gods of Israel.
What the hell?
So that's like it. These be thy gods, O Israel, which brought thee up out of the land of Egypt.
Mm. Oh, man, they constructed new gods right after the Most High released them out of captivity, man. Immediately afterwards, man.
Wow.
Because Moses had delayed his coming. He was up there at Mount Sinai receiving law, statutes, commandments. So these niggas down here took up all their gold and made a golden calf to worship after all they saw.
And said that this golden calf delivered them. What a slap same. In the Lord's face. That's why the Lord ain't gonna deliver all Jake.
That's right. Right.
You
That's
niggas right. gonna remain on the soils of America and you're gonna die, man.
Yep.
Straight up.
Yep. Because it's like we're on the mountain right now, okay? And y'all still out there doing building a calf right now.
Right, yeah.
Okay? The Lord said to come out of her, man. Come out of this place. Come out of this wickedness. You see, right. It's nothing but wickedness going on all around you.
Right.
Okay? And our people look at it and just turn their head like it ain't even happening, man.
That's why okay? The Lord said, let them guys save you.
Yeah.
Let them come and get you.
Right. God. All right, yeah, we'll go back to Jeremiah.
That's crazy.
Then we get that Hebrew.
Can I get one real quick? This is Zephaniah 1 and 12. It says, and it shall come to pass at that time that I will search Jerusalem with candles and punish the men that are settled on their leaves, that say in their hearts, the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai will not do good. Neither will he do evil.
It's wickedness.
It's complacency. It's set up on their knees, man. Lord ain't gonna do this, Lord ain't gonna do that.
Right.
It's the promise that was coming, you know?
And that's a person that's not even looking for mercy or wrath.
Well, they don't believe nothing's gonna happen.
They
right.
Don't believe nothing's gonna happen.
I mean, that their fear is in Esau.
Yeah. That's why it's gonna be so easy them for them to take that micro C hill. It's going to be so easy because it's going to be right there in their face, okay? And the fact that they can't go to the store, they can't buy or sell, it's going to be right there in their face. And Esau is going to present them with the solution, which is that thing right there, okay?
Hey, it's easy for them to take the jab.
Yeah, real easy.
Easy for them to take that jab.
Real easy. Time when Esau said you can't go to the store.
Yeah. Can't go to the club.
Can't
right.
go to work.
Yeah.
You can't hop on a plane. Oh, them niggas said, nah, we can't have that.
Man.
Go ahead,
hit me.
Shit. All for that. You know, turn, you know, it's not required for them.
The motherfuckers feel stupid now.
Yeah.
Hey, that type of mindset is a person that goes along with the get along.
Scared, bro.
They're just living for whatever's going on.
Scripture say what? My people are led as a flock to the slaughter, man.
Hey, that's what
they call them. They call them sheeple, man.
Yeah. It's the gift of trusting in man.
What's that scripture right. where it said, let them God save you? Where is that at?
Jeremiah 11. Oh, save you? Oh, that one says, hear you.
Huh? You can no, I'm saying, like, it's like when the Lord said, let them.
Oh, Jeremiah 11.
It's, I guess we'll put that. It said Jeremiah 11 and 11. Salah. Therefore, thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring evil upon them, which they shall not be able to escape. And though they shall cry unto me, I will not hearken unto them. Then shall the cities of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem go and cry unto the gods whom they have offered incense, but they shall not save them at all in the time of their trouble. That's a good one. But I wanted the one where it says, that is it Judges? When the Lord said, let them God save you?
Yeah,
I don't have my sword, man, you know?
Huh?
Let those gods live you the day of trouble.
That was a good one though, bro.
John.
Okay.
Day of trouble.
I don't know how to word it, you know? I think it's judges though.
Judges 10.
Judges 10?
What? It says save me. Don't cry to the God which ye have chosen.
That's the one.
Oh yeah, Judges 10 and 14.
Hey, get that.
Judges 10 and 14. Go and cry unto the gods which ye have chosen.
Alright, that's what the Lord said to you, Jakes, when he brings his wrath. But you're gonna find out, just like them gods in Egypt could have saved them Egyptians, these gods of this society that the white man told you or taught you are not gonna be able to save you, man. Go ahead.
Go and cry out to the gods which ye have chosen. Let them deliver you in the time of your tribulation.
Right, what's some of those gods? Jesus Christos, Jesus Christ,
Virgin Mary,
Guadalupe, your fucking Federal Reserve note, your status, how many followers you got, whatever the hell it is, man.
They women and shit.
Your woman, let your woman save you. Motherfuckers gonna be looking to that woman.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Hey, remember it. Hey, Jake was saying black woman is God, right?
Yeah.
Black woman is God.
My ass. Jeez.
My queen.
Yeah.
Fucking damn. That's
because Jake hate order. They know if when they come up to Yahweh Shim Yahweh Shai, they're gonna have to get in order. Okay, they don't want no order. They want their own order.
Yep.
Okay? So it's easy. It's easy to pray to a God that says you can come as you are.
Do anything you want.
Do anything you want to do.
That's Satanism.
That's Satanism, exactly. Okay?
Yeah, a bunch of so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans are Satanists, man.
Yeah.
You do what you want. You do what thou wilt. You wasn't put on the planet to do what you want. Just like a kid, your child, they can't do what they want under your roof. Hell no! You want to do what you want, you're going to have to do that somewhere else.
Yeah.
Because there's rules when it comes to this house.
Yeah, right.
So there's rules being on this planet, being an Israelite on this planet. There's rules.
That's right. So if you don't want to follow the Most High's rule, get the hell out.
Get out.
That's what he did. He kicking you out. All right, fend for yourself. When the time of Jacob's troubles come, fend for yourself.
Ooh.
Okay? When you're going to be there crying, big mighty man crying like a little girl.
Yep.
Okay?
Rebellious is in the witchcraft.
There we go, bro.
Our people are rebellious. 2/3 of our people are just full of rebels, man. They don't want to follow the law. They want to continue eating pork, tell you can't eat pork. They still want to eat pork, man.
Yeah, they're rebels and wickedness.
Yeah.
You could be a rebel in righteousness, but they're rebels and wickedness, man. You know? You rebel against the right way.
Right.
And stand up for the wicked way. What's that scripture? Get that scripture where it says it's an abomination. They're abomination. Basically, if you justify the wicked, it's abomination.
We rebel against Esau, man. We rebelled against him, against his M-A-R-K. Okay, we rebelled against his Maxine, all right? We're rebelling against that. That's rebelling in righteousness, man. Okay?
It's Isaiah 58 and 1. Cry aloud, spare not. Lift up that voice like a trumpet.
That's what we do every week, man. Cry loud, spare not. Lift up that voice like a trumpet, man. Let our people know what they're going off. Alright?
Yeah. Show my people their transgressions.
Show them your transgressions, man. No, you can't eat pork. No, you can't have sex on the Sabbath. Alright? Yeah.
And the house of Jacob, their sins.
Jacob and Israel. You know, Jacob, Israelites, is what it's all about. So Jacob, their sins.
Exactly. And when we're showing you your sins, that's for you to repent. Okay? That's the reason we're here. The reason we're out here is for you to repent. Okay? Not to just you to know your sins. Okay? Make you aware of them so you'll be able to repent and Lord willing get salvation, man. Okay? There's no other way but to repent.
It's Proverbs 17 and 15. He that justifieth the wicked, and he that condemneth the just, even they both are an abomination to the Lord. So our people be justifying the wicked, man. You know, they justify trannies and homosexuals, man. They justify smoking and adultery. You know, they justify idol worship. You know, but want to speak against the righteous way.
Right.
Hey, nah, that's gonna get you killed, man.
And quick to go against the word of the Lord.
Yeah.
Okay.
Scripture said, "He that despises the word shall be destroyed." All right.
Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 14. Behold, all souls are mine. As the soul of the Father, so also the soul of the Son is mine. The soul that sinneth, it shall die.
Oh, I saw that.
What's the wages of sin?
Yeah.
There you go. Okay? People act like they forgot the Most High's laws, man. As if the Most High didn't change.
Nope.
Okay? The Most High is the same today, yesterday, and tomorrow, man.
That's right.
Okay?
That's right. Sin is death. Word is life.
That's right. That's why the Lord, when he makes that new covenant with us, what is he going to do? He's going to program us not to sin, man.
That's right. That's right.
You know?
And we're going to be unstoppable after that. We're going to be unstoppable, boy.
Force to be reckoned with.
You ain't going to be able to touch us, boy.
No. You're not going to even be able to have a thought against us, man. Okay? We're going to know your thoughts. All right?
What's that scripture? Words, that they are life. Words, that they are life.
John 7. No, John 6. Man, what is that?
Oh, I got it right here.
John 6, John 7.
You got it? Oh, you got
it. You got it. Well,
I wasn't sure that was. I wasn't sure that was.
It's John 6 or John 7. John 6, 63. I got it.
Okay.
It is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. So I get that. Call it out. John 6 and 63. It is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life.
That's right. Brother brought the scripture about how sin is death. Well, hey, what's life? These words. It's that the spirit quickeneth. It's the spirit that gives you that life.
Right.
It's the words that are life as well, man. The flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life, man. So that's how you want to find life. Just deal with this word. Deal with this truth.
Tail swing.
Yeah, man. You got something?
Yeah. I got some.
Go back to that Jeremiah.
I gave you one point. You got it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 31. Cast away from you all your transgressions, whereby he hath transgressed, and make you a new heart and a new spirit. For why will he die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of him that died, saith the Lord, Yahweh, my Shem El Shai. Wherefore, turn yourselves and live ye.
Cast off thy transgression. What does it say about the heart?
He says,
it's the heart, it's your mind.
And make you a new heart and a new spirit. And the truth gives you a spirit.
Something different about you.
Yeah.
Everything is different.
Yeah. Your spirit is on you.
Yeah. And they hate it. They try to get you to go back to doing the old things.
Yeah.
Okay? That's what they don't want to see you
doing good. They don't want to see you falling after righteousness, man. Okay?
After a while, they got respect.
Yep.
Because they see you not smoking no more. You ain't out here tattooed up. You ain't following the trends.
Especially in a pork thing. You ain't eating a ham, okay? You go to the Thanksgiving dinner, okay, but you're not eating a ham. You know you ate ham.
This one Jake was trying to show me a picture of his girl. Man, my girl's so bad. Like, it's like, you trying, I'm like, nah, man, that's all you. Like,
yeah, I don't want to see that.
It's like, I respect him. I respect him.
Importantly, they see that manhood in you. They see you walking as a man.
Yeah.
And they never saw that before. No?
Yeah. That's the problem with niggas. They want to show off their bitch.
Yeah.
And then somebody end up smacking your bitch.
Yeah.
I mean, piping your bitch.
Yeah.
Come on, man. You keep that at home, man. That's for your eyes only, man.
Yeah.
It's just like showing your bank account. Pulling out all your money. Like, look what I got.
Right. You know? Leaving your garage open.
Hey, yeah. That's how people get robbed.
Exactly.
You sure when you put how much money you got at the bank, that's how you get robbed.
Yeah.
You know? I won't think my brother died. Played, he was number 21 on the Washington Redskins. He had a party, and he invited a bunch of people. The two niggas that saw everything in his house there that night came down and robbed him. Ended up putting him to death.
So that's not when he thinks shit out, huh?
Jake wanted to be all flashy and show his shit off.
Hey, that's that, that one king. He showed the Babylonians, Bill Hezekiah. This is the prophet Isaiah. He shows Babylon all everything they had in his house. And eventually later on, Babylon besieged Jerusalem. Took over Jerusalem, took all the temples, and they took all the gold and everything that they had, that Judah had. If I'm not mistaken, I believe that was Hezekiah.
Ezekiel 18 and 27. Again, when the wicked man turned away from his wickedness that he had committed and do it that which is lawful and right, he shall save his soul alive. And then jumping to 31, cast away from you all your transgressions, whereby he hath transgressed, and make you a new heart and a new spirit.
Yeah, make you a new heart and a new spirit. What did King David pray for, man? Renew the spirit within him, man. You always got to pray to keep that spirit fresh, renewed within you, man.
Right
on. You know? Because the devil is always at work, something was going into last week, man. The devil's always like a roaring lion, man.
Well,
and keep
stop.
That spirit in fresh.
Shit, Esau don't stop.
Dark Lord
Satan.
Yeah.
Gotta keep that armor on, man.
Hey, we on 27 again?
Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 27. And it says, again, when the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness that he had committed, and doeth that which is lawful and right, he shall save his soul alive.
That's being repentant, man. That's repentance, man. Turning away, turning back. Turning away from the transgression that you can save yourself, man. Come back to life. Time around, man. The second time around, they're gonna have to go through that fire. You know?
Go ahead.
But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, saith the Lord, I will put my law in their inward parts and write it in their hearts, and will be their God, and they shall be my people.
Yeah, the Lord is actually going to force us to do the right thing.
In the thumbnail, it says to be inscribed in their heart, then all Israel will know the Lord.
Yeah, all Israel should know the Lord, man. Remember, we got to teach our neighbor, go before. Nobody knows that scripture, I'll figure that out.
No, that's the same verse, same. Jeremiah 31.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro, keep reading.
Verse 34. And they shall teach no more every man his neighbor, and every man his brother, saying, know the Lord. But they shall all know me, from the least of them unto the greatest of them, saith the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity, and will remember their sin no more.
Yeah, so you're not going to have to set up camp. You're not going to have to go out to the streets no more.
Right.
You know, teach our people. We're all going to know the Lord, man.
That JK won't be lost. They ain't gonna be calling themselves by, you know, Mexican or whatever.
They ain't gonna give you that evil eye.
They ain't gonna be cursed no more.
They ain't gonna be like, hey, show one.
Yeah.
You know, they're gonna sleep each other. Oh, you're one of Zion's sons.
Ah.
Oh, you come from Abijah's lineage. Okay.
House of Zion.
Yeah. Your house of Shammai. Okay.
Hey, your woman ain't gonna be a demon no more. She gonna really love you and shit. She gonna know how to share you, you know. She ain't gonna try to hinder you from getting another box, you know?
Yeah. Hey, she's righteous, she's gonna go out there and find another wife. This is what they did in the ancient world.
Shit, all the women, you got the leg, all the women gonna want you.
Yeah. Hey, like, Jacob and, Leah and Rachel, they gave Jacob maids. Same thing with, Sarah.
Yep.
Sarah gave, that guy to Abraham. And it was no jealousy involved.
True. Same with, oh yeah, you already mentioned Jacob, right?
Hey, they had no, like,
they weren't in America, man.
Right.
Our people weren't destroyed, man.
Sure.
They knew where they were. They had customs, man.
Man, there's no customs here.
Shit, Babylonian customs.
Shit.
Christmas.
What is Babylon?
Confusion,
right? That's all this place is. That's all it brings. It's confusion. You have people that believe in this, people that believe in that, people that two different beliefs. You got all different nations all here in Babylon, you know, doing their own thing.
When was there a time where our people didn't grow up with fathers, man? When was there a time like that, bro?
Only here.
Only in America, bro.
Only in America.
It's a big curse.
Our harshest
father. The only father's in the house.
Our harshest captivity.
So we need Yahushua to come back, and that's the big thing right here.
Alright.
Well, then, start this.
Alright. Yeah, like you spoke about, Lord, showing mercy to our people. He's not going to deliver this time.
Right.
Jake don't want to be saved. Jake don't want to leave America. That's all they know.
That's how they were acting under this. Like, they wanted to go back. Like the Lord saving them.
Reminiscent
of
Egypt.
Yeah.
Why?
True. You can tell Jake you can have multiple wives. You don't have a problem with that.
That's why I'm a one-woman man.
You can tell Jake that you have servants.
Jake a one-woman man, they got 10 cars. You got 1,000 shoes, but you a one-woman man?
Yeah,
fuck out of here, man. Fuck out of here, dog.
Jake has a problem with slaves, man. Well, that's coming big.
Yeah, they have a problem having these other nations in slavery. They have a problem getting their vengeance.
Yeah, Jake want to be equal with everybody. He had that egalitarian mindset. So we're not equal. We're above these people. We're above
better.
Yeah, we're better
than these. And what's wrong with that?
Lord made us that way. He made us better than each other nations.
Right, yeah, a nation of kings and priests.
Yep. We're both all nations that are on the face of the earth. Let's not forget that.
I mean, yeah.
A lot of people are so docile and nothing but degenerates that they are in a lower state. And ultimately, we'll see how much Shara put us in this lower state. So this lower state, you know, how, if you see how Jake is today, how low we are, just imagine when we get back get to a higher state, man, when the Lord lifts us up.
Our best state.
Right, start with his flesh. To the point where even Balaam, he saw how Jake was in the kingdom. He wished that he was an Israelite. Damn.
Yeah. Jake don't want that. He really doesn't believe it. He's been beat down, that slave mentality, his whole life. But he really doesn't believe it.
Right.
He really thinks he's a nigger on the spot.
Yeah, Jake wants the money, man. Jake wants money and fame in this time.
They like the bigger picture, man. Like the scripture says, man, without vision, they perish, man. But they don't see anything past this place. Hey, Jake's been broken down like a person.
They think righteousness is born.
Yeah.
Ah, righteousness comes order, man.
Yeah.
Righteousness.
Like Notorious B.I.G., right? He said, I don't wanna be in heaven with the goody goodies.
Yeah.
Fuck that shit. I wear black Tims and black hoodies. Some shit like that. You know? He said, God would probably have me on some real strict shit. No sleeping all day, no getting my dick licked, some shit like that, you know?
Yeah.
Like, man, you don't know what you're talking about, dude.
Yeah.
Come on, man. You don't know what you're talking about, man.
That's like Christian church. That warped the minds of
right.
People.
Yeah, saying that you can't have sex to your marriage.
Yeah.
You don't know what marriage is.
Yeah.
You know?
And then you think that when Rebecca saw Isaac, that Isaac had to bow down to her to marry? Nah, man, he went into the tent.
Hey, she put her veil on.
Yeah.
I show you the spirit that she was in. She was in a real feminist spirit. She put her veil on, man. You know? You know, she took it off when she got in that tent. You know, it was
yeah.
On.
Yeah.
You know?
Jake, they don't have the truth in the Bible, man. Right, like Christian church and Catholic church fucked our people up, man. Believe in righteousness is a goody-goody shit, man. The Lord is a man of war, man.
That's
a killer, man. What are you talking about?
Yeah,
man. Daniel was a fucking mass murderer, man.
And he was putting it down, man. King Solomon had 1,000 women, man.
Yeah.
You think the Lord is against you having a woman? No, man. The Lord created the woman for the man.
Right.
Gave the purpose of, gave woman big lips, big tits, and a nice curvy.
For who? For the man.
That's right.
For our pleasure.
There you go.
King Solomon had 1,000 wives.
You know what I'm saying? The Lord made them desirable, man.
Yeah.
He made sex pleasurable like that. Come on, man. Make it stupid, man.
But there's rules and regulations when it comes to sex, too.
That's right,
yeah,
bro.
Can't just
right.
Be doing wicked shit out here.
Right, no. Can't go on the ass.
Yeah.
Can't have orgies.
Can't be piping a woman on the period, man. She's unclean, man. Even Jake don't want to hear that, you know. No.
That's why you got multiple women for that reason.
Dang.
Right.
We ain't even experienced that yet. You know, we know it's right, but. Like the Lord gave us multiple women. Nah, man, we still having to deal with one woman.
None.
We still being deprived, all fucked up.
Yeah, whether you have one or none, regardless, you're deprived.
Fucked up out here, man.
Or captivity. Man. Jake wanna stay here. It's all good, though.
Hey, but them Jakes that get high in this world, they still got women problems.
Yeah.
Rapper, that's what he is. Why is he talking about women? You got your nails painted, nigga. You's a bitch. I mean, you and your fucking bitches going into nails done together, man. What type of shit is that? Go ahead,
Ezekiel chapter 16:8. Now when I passed by thee and I look upon thee, behold, thy time was the time of love, and I spread my skirt over thee, and covered thy nakedness. Yea, I swear unto thee, and entered into a covenant with thee, said the Lord Yahweh, and thou becamest mine.
That's going back to the beginning.
Yeah, it's like Brother Rob, he was a husband unto us. But this was going to come back to us, bro, that husbandship, the Lord giving us, like a husband giving his wife the best of everything, that's what's going to come back. It says, then I washed thee with water, yea, I truly washed away thy blood from thee, and I anointed thee with oil. I clothed thee also with broidered work, and shod thee with badger skin, and I girded thee with fine linen, and I covered thee with silk.
Covering our nakedness. Yeah. Right now we're walking out here naked and shameful. The Lord's going to cover all that. Give us back our nationality. Give us back our rightful position on this planet, this galaxy.
He's going to cover us with the best things, bro.
It's going to come one day, man.
Yeah. Hey, like, I wish I said, I go and prepare a place for you. Just like how, so when you go in the commentary, just like how a husband builds and prepares his place for his wife. Builds a comfortable house, comfortable home for his wife.
Quarters.
Right. So, just like Yahushua, we're locking onto his woman. All right? And when the marriage ceremony comes, he's going to give us the things that he has prepared for his elect. Lord willing, us brothers are part of that, you know?
Right. Scripture saying the wife have made herself ready.
Right. And, so, and when you go into ancient customs, how women would get married, they would, oh, you got more?
The water, brother.
The water.
Water.
I needed some.
Water, bro. The water, huh? How about smell sharp like thighs?
Sharp like thighs, so long, brother.
I want.
She could have moved over to the other lane.
Yeah, I like that. Hey, so just like how...
Oh, you like you?
I'm not talking about
these,
but yeah, I like
these,
bro. Come on now.
Hey,
my brother.
I'm
talking about the Nike she got on.
It's on Sipanya, you know?
Oh, you like that Air Force style? New Air Force style, I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Like hey, just...
Air Force Ones? I got some.
Hey, just like how in the ancient world, a woman, she would bathe herself for like a year in oils, right? And how are we doing that? We're bathing ourselves with this word, with this wisdom, and righteousness to the best of our ability. Waiting for our Lord Yahushua. Lord willing, we are worthy to enter into the marriage chamber, into the chariot, you know?
That's right.
Hey,
you're either chosen or you're not.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's scary part, bro.
Hi.
I had a precept for that Jeremiah.
I take thee also with ornaments, and I put bracelets upon thy hands, and a chain on thy neck, and I put jewel on thy foreheads, and earrings in thy ears, and a beautiful crown upon thy head. Thus was thou decked with gold and silver, thy raiment was of fine linen, and silk embroidered work. Thus didst eat fine flour, honey, and oil, and was exceeding beautiful, and didst prosper into a kingdom.
That's right. Get that beauty back. That's right. Get the jewels back. That's why Jake, this is Jake's spirit. Wear our jewelry, you know, chains, rings. That's in our spirit. We have all that.
We're the Israelites.
Yeah.
We're Israelites. No, we're not Jewish, we're Israelites. We're the real Jews.
Yeah. I'm also an Israelite. All right, bro. Yeah, you know, brothers, we read the whole list. You know, all the fine jewels, those precious things, man. We're going to get that back. You know?
Yeah, not just that, the food, the fine flour,
and the real food.
have streets made out of pure gold.
Yeah, it's like gold and silver. Yeah, gold and silver.
Hey. Yeah, we're going to build up our kingdom with all kinds of precious jewels. You know? Carbuncle helped get that revelation. Revelation. We're going to do all these different jewels and gems that we're going to build our kingdom up with. We got a beautiful thing coming, man.
That's right.
That reward is coming, man.
Revelation chapter 21, verse 9. And there came unto me one of the seven angels which had the seven vials full of the seven last plagues, and talked with me, saying, come hither, I will show thee the bride, the Lamb's wife. And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain, and showed me the great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of the heaven from the Lord.
In vision of the kingdom.
Having the glory of the Lord, and her light was like unto a stone, precious, most precious, even like as jasper stone, crystal as clear. And it had a wall great and high, and had 12 gates, and the gates 12 angels, and the names written therein, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. On the east, 3 gates, on the north, 3 gates, on the south, 3 gates, on the west, 3 gates.
And when you think of gates, what do you think of, like a city? Like, you know, Lord gonna beautify us, man.
Yeah. It says,
hey, them rats ain't got that.
I ain't got that, bro.
Ain't that the real jewelry?
It's cool stuff. My bad. It says in the scriptures how our gates are gonna be open continually, man. We're gonna get the finest of everything from these different heathens out here. What they have to offer, man, it's going to come to us. All right?
First of everything, y'all get the land.
Yeah. Y'all get the scraps.
Just like we get the scraps in this world. Just give me a second. The first shall be last. And the last shall be first.
What verse are you at?
Verse 12. Just jump on 18. It's verse 18. It says, and the building of the wall of it was like a jasper, and the city was pure gold, like unto clear glass.
Walls made out of pure jasper, man.
And hey, look at that car. See, that made me think
that's
of
like
opal.
Oh,
opal, yeah, that's spirit, bro. That's a spirit, bro.
Jesus. Imagine your walls look like that, man.
Yeah. But like clear glass, where you can see the reflection. Like
better than that.
Better than that. Like you will see yourself in it, bro.
Opal?
No, she said it's a wrap.
The wrap.
But it's like the opal stone.
Nice. Okay. Cool.
Nice.
Yeah, there's this one stone, opal stone. I think it's called like the galaxy or something like that. Yeah. You shine a light on it, it looks exactly like the damn galaxy.
Yeah.
Bro.
Dang, it is opal, bro.
That's one of the prettiest stones out there, man. That's just the stones that we know about. You know, Esau got the stones. You know, that glow in the dark.
Oh, I got three of those. But I put it in the sun in the night. It glows in the dark.
Man. What's that one called?
I don't know. It was a gift. Give it to me.
Yeah.
Man, that thing is beautiful, bro.
Real?
So, yeah. We're like a rainbow and ocean.
I think it looks better than a
Galaxy.
Yeah, it's going to choke it too.
Opal stone.
Verse 19. It says that the foundations of the wall of the city were garnished with all manner of precious stones. The first foundation was jasper, the second sapphire, the third a chalcedony, and the fourth, emerald.
Emerald, that's one of my favorites, man.
Yeah, green.
Emerald. Green, yeah. love everyone, man. It's a beautiful story.
It says, the fifth, Sardonyx. The sixth, Sardius. The seventh, Crystallite. And the eighth, Beryl.
Beryl. Beryl. It's the color of your house shy wore, man. Green.
Good. It says, the ninth, a topaz. The tenth, Cryosulfurus. The 11th, Shakin. The 12th, Amethyst.
Amethyst, yeah. It's a real popular stone.
Yeah, if y'all put all these stones together, what do you think that stones look together? They look like the colors from the rainbow. Right. That's how the Lord gets down, man. And the stone is a rainbow. There's colors everywhere. That's why Jake loves colors so much, man. In the kingdom, it's going to be lively. There's not going to be a dull section. You ever go to East on England, and there's like a dull neighborhood, and it's just boring houses and shit?
It's all spirit is
going. Gray and shit, all colors,
In the kingdom, it's going to be colorful, bro.
Bright,
And like the brothers are saying, man, those stones have a vibration, man. They serve a purpose, man. We're going to know the true knowledge of that in the kingdom, man. All right?
Experience is true.
What it was meant for.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, man. Sir, you'll know which stone to link up with another stone. And, on this side, you can read up on a stone. You'll forget what the hell the stone does. The kingdom way ain't going to forget, man.
Yo, y'all brothers ever play Minecraft? I used to like playing Was it Minecraft? The shit where you build?
Tetris?
Yeah, it's like Minecraft, right? And I played it on PS4, and what I like to do is grab the stones and make houses out of it. Them shits look beautiful, bro. Like stones built into a house.
Yeah. Kingdom, hey, it's the colors that we haven't seen yet. It's like a spirit world.
I like that lavender right stone. That's one of my favorite stones. Lavender right. One time I was doing grub up in Hollywood, and I had walked into an establishment. Agate countertops. Countertops. Oh god damn. Oh, you're going Epsy right now. You type in agate stone, take agate. Agate, man, that shit is, this shit look like beautiful water and wood together. Agate comes in all type of colors, man. That's a beautiful stone. That's one of them, man. That's one of them stones right there, man. Agate, amethyst, jasper, lavender right, onyx is real nice. What's that one? The blue one? Sapphire. But it's another name. Another name for it.
Sapphire.
Right, the scriptures is known as sapphire, but lapis.
Lapis.
Yeah, it's blue.
Yeah, that's
a real nice phone.
But actually, on other planets, there's one planet where it actually rains sapphire.
Esau says that.
Hey, shit.
That's
stones
that would hurt like a mother.
Yeah.
It's raining stones on you?
Like, raining diamonds and shit. He said that this planet would rain diamonds.
Yeah.
But who knows? But hey.
Yeah, he would say that,
But you go to other planets, man. You know there's some stones out there that can get mined out there. Drop that.
That's what they were trying to do with that movie Avatar.
And in the second one, it was like that the thing in the back of the whale's throat.
Oh yeah,
it was like that fluid that they were extracting from the whale.
It made up the corner like that.
Yeah.
Which one's better?
They're both the same.
Yeah. The last one, I like it a lot. Because I was on high shot, and I was just the water scene of it.
But that's how the kingdom's gonna seem like that.
Yeah.
It's gonna be like, hey, we're gonna experience new things like the brother saying.
Every day gonna be a new experience.
I got some.
It says,
what you got, bro? I got some too.
Hold it.
13?
Yeah, me too.
Okay. It says, verse 21, and the 12 gates were 12 pearls, and every several gate was one of pearl. It says in the street.
Pearls are real nice too.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Nice.
And they give like they can kind of give a little different colors when you put it in the sun, like a glare. Them things beautiful, bro.
Yeah.
take a long time for them to pull a pearl out of a clam.
Yeah.
It takes years for the thing to develop inside that clam. That's why it's so expensive.
Renovation,
none of that, man. Yeah. Never, bro,
never.
Esau
could
be right there to fix those renovations.
I mean,
continue employment.
Well, he bashed his head in the wall. Alright, we just gotta put a hole in the wall real quick. Go ahead and fix that, boy.
Ain't gonna be no potholes, ain't gonna be no more cars.
Yeah.
Or trucks. That's the main reason why it causes these potholes anyway.
Well, the rain causes it, really.
Yeah.
Rain, potholes developed after the rain. It softens up this fucking weak ass asphalt.
Man, you have the truck, man.
Yeah, fresh cars.
Yeah,
yeah,
no cars. Go back to riding horses and our chariots.
Ain't nobody gonna lay no motherfucking, what's this shit called? Asphalt.
We're gonna have road work here in the Kingdom of Heaven. We gotta.
So we gonna be in the skies, man. It ain't gonna be like this, man.
Smog. Nah, man.
You gonna be able to see the ocean again? No, we're supposed to be able to see the ocean from here, you know?
There's some trees, we're having big ass trees again.
Hey, everyone's gonna rejoice, like I said. The righteous are in the void, but the people, they rejoice.
Now, I'm trees, trying to get there, man. Insects wanna get there, man.
Yeah.
Literally a perfect world, man.
That's
perfect
it.
World. Well, we're perfect in it too, bro. What the hell? That sounds good to me.
First Saw 22.
The real New World Order.
Yeah. It says, and I saw no temple therein, for the Lord Almighty and the Lamb are the temple of it. And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon to shine in it. For the glory of the Lord did light it, and the Lamb is the light thereof.
That's going back to what we read in Jeremiah 31. You know, no man's going to have to teach his neighbor.
Right.
You know, the truth is always going to be there. The sun is going to be there forever. It's going to have the sun, but still have the moon. It's that, you know, we're going to have the truth, that righteousness, that wisdom, the truth is always going to be there, that true light. You know, that's what scripture's talking about.
We're never going to go back in the darkness again.
Right? Never, ever.
Never.
Never. Never.
And never go off again.
Yeah.
Never have a wicked thought.
Isaiah 60 goes into the sun and the moon. The sun and the moon. Oh shit.
Wrap it up. Oh, it just popped up? Oh, shit. Somebody dropped it, huh?
Over here,
I didn't see it, bro.
Yeah,
where'd it come from?
Oh, I got mine. I'm good. I'm good.
No, I'm saying from where? Yeah. Which direction? No, that direction. That's funny.
Alright, so
is
it over there?
God. Brother said
you
had a piece
of it. Yeah, get that Tobit out. Tobit 13:10. Tobit 13:9. Oh, Jerusalem, thy holy city. He will scourge thee for thy children's work, and will have mercy again on the sins of the righteous. Give praise to the Lord, for he is good, and praise the everlasting King, that his tabernacle may be built in thee again with joy, and let him make joyful there in thee those that are captives, and love in thee forever those that are miserable. Many nations shall come from far to the name of the Lord God, Yahweh Shai, with gifts in their hands, even gifts to the King of heaven. All generations shall praise thee with great joy. Cursed are they which hate thee, and blessed shall all be which love thee forever. Rejoice and be glad for the children of the just. They shall be gathered together and shall bless the Lord of all the just. Oh, blessed are they which love thee, for they shall rejoice in thy peace. Blessed are they which have been sorrowful for all thy scourges. They shall rejoice for thee when they have seen all thy glory, and shall be glad forever. Let my soul bless the Most High, the great King, for Jerusalem shall be built up with sapphires, emeralds, and precious stones.
Sapphire, like I said, is that lapis lazuli, whatever it's called.
Yeah.
That's blue. Read that again, that blue, that sapphire.
For Jerusalem shall be built up with sapphires.
Hey, I remember there was someone that seen the Heavenly Father's feet and heard his feet.
Nah.
It captures everyone, too.
Alright. That's cool.
Yeah, I wonder how long they got that.
For Jerusalem shall be built up with sapphires and emeralds and precious stones. Thy walls and towers and battlements with pure gold. And the streets of Jerusalem shall be paved with beryl and carbuncle and stones of Ophir. Which, hey, carbuncle is Levi's stone, the red one. And that's a stone that no one can really get here. It's hard to find. Go to all these stone places, these warehouses, they never have that specific stone. But Ophir is like the purest gold, the best gold you can get. And all his streets shall say hallelujah, basically. And they shall praise him, saying, blessed be the Most High, which shall extol it forever.
Alright,
that's why the street says, the heathen shall envy thee, they shall not be able to do nothing against thee. It's just like how we were talking about earlier before camp, you know, going to Bel Air, Santa Barbara, this looks nice. Yeah. It makes you, and like the car said, it makes you want to envy these devils, you know? So I feel so tired, like again, these devils, how they live.
They're living it up.
They're living good.
And they've been living it up.
And it's nice out here. And it's nice, but that ain't shit compared to the kingdom of heaven. That's nothing.
Not even close, bro.
You cannot compare it to how these devils are living, to how we're going to live soon. You can't compare it.
Can't compare it. Santa Barbara's a beautiful area, man.
All greenery, nice beach views.
Go down Laguna Beach.
Go to
Miguel. Beautiful areas, but you can't compare it to what we just read.
We're only talking about California.
Yeah.
We're about Switzerland. All the places over there. Right.
Nice. Oh, Oregon. Did you see Oregon? There's some places out there. Just...
And nice. As nice as it is, as nice as California is, the Lord will destroy it. So you know what we got coming is far better than this.
Right.
You know our land specifically is, it has to be great, bro. I honestly feel like, I ain't gonna say I honestly feel like, but my humble opinion, because I love California weather, bro. My man gotta feel like it. Got to. Gotta be this or better.
The land,
better.
Israel.
Better,
The land of Israel is like the best land.
Land of milk and honey. Once the Israelites are back in that land, it's gonna flourish. know?
Yeah, like when you go into our world of milk, it goes into abundance. Okay? The abundance of this land offered. Okay?
Yeah, it ain't gonna be no dry desert like it is now.
Right.
Ooh. See pictures of Israel right now, it's all desert, dirt,
yeah, there's gonna be no need for any trees.
Yeah.
You know, amen. It's gonna be dry, thriving like the brothers are saying. Because the right people are gonna be in that land. Our people.
I see why the Lord has us wait. It's so great, you gotta wait.
Yeah.
It's so great, you gotta wait.
Yeah. I got a preset. It's Luke 5:5.
Somebody grab Isaiah 60, you know what I'm
saying? Arise, O Jerusalem, and stand on high, and look about toward the east, and behold, thy children gathered from the west unto the east by the word of the Holy One, rejoicing in the remembrance of the Most High. For they departed from thee on foot, and were led away of the enemies, but the Most High bringeth them unto the exalted, that's what he says, but the Most High bringeth them unto thee, exalted with glory as children of thy kingdom. For the Most High appointed that every high hill and banks of long continuance should be cast down, and the valleys filled up, to make even the ground that Israel may go safely in the glory of the Most High. Moreover, even the woods and every sweet-smelling tree shall overshadow Israel by the commandment of the Most High.
Bro, what is that like, bro?
Sweet-smelling
tree, bro.
What?
Like,
wake up in the morning,
like,
everything's smelling good.
Nah, but certain trees give off, like, the pine tree give off a certain scent, you know?
Yeah, but that's why you go up in that, the sequoia, you don't smell what you're smelling now in the city.
We smell, I don't smell like that.
Here?
No, it's
like
okay.
Fresh, you can smell the river water.
There's a lot of oxygen there.
Ooh, yeah, it smells good. It smells fresh.
Clear air, yeah.
It really smells fresh.
Like, now,
The lakes, it's fresh.
Like,
it really,
it's,
you know?
Hey, bro. That's why you ever buy those car air freshener? The little.
Yeah, like the pine.
It's like the trees.
Yeah, it's sweet. It's a sweet smelling tree. You should be able to go out. This tree should give out a scent, man. Pine tree.
Pine trees are abundance down south, you know? Georgia, pine trees everywhere.
That's greenery,
you know? Yeah. You can smell that pine tree, you know?
Cool. It's real, the air is real clear out there.
Yeah, some places.
Some places.
Yeah, but you can smell that pine tree, you know? It's a real stick smell.
In the kingdom, we're going to have natural air fresheners on the whole time. The trees.
Say, you won't need an air freshener.
That is going to be the air freshener.
Yeah, the air freshener is the trees.
I remember talking to brothers that went there. They pretty much said out, like, even the old guys, Eagle Mines over there, man, you know, that they were healthily, you know, full of energy and shit, hiking and shit.
Man, yeah,
that's
bro.
That's what that fresh air does, man.
Yeah.
It's good for that. The oxygen is good for the brain.
Yeah.
Goddamn, Edom, I got like a cart full of heavy backpacks. Going up about like 5 miles, hike uphill straight.
Yeah.
And his whole family, like, I'm like, where are you going with all that stuff? I'm going all the way to the top of the hill. You're going with all that stuff. You got kids, wife, and you're going to be carrying all that up that hill. All right, damn. Got it, man.
Yeah. In contrast with here, man, there's nothing but camtrail, smog, all kind of shit, man, trying to kill us.
Yeah, and not just that, but people smoking cigarettes and shit.
Yeah.
Shit, it's horrible,
all
man.
All type of frequencies hit you.
Yeah.
Routers,
everything.
I can't stand
cigarettes. Well, I got another precept. Isaiah 51:3. For the Lord shall comfort Zion, he will comfort all her waste places. And he will make her wilderness like Eden, and her desert like the garden of the Lord.
What do you know? You know Eden means, Zion?
Eden?
Oh.
I remember that.
Joy and gladness. Joy and gladness.
Paradise.
Joy and gladness.
Paradise.
Yeah, paradise of joy.
Oh, yeah.
Hebrew is Idon.
Paradise.
Joy and gladness shall be found therein.
The earth is known as paradise, no?
Yeah.
But he saw them turn it into a wilderness, man.
Turn it into a goddamn.
He done destroyed this place, man. The scriptures say, destroy them that destroyed the earth. This guy is guilty of destroying the earth, man, and the Lord's creation. And they want to act as if it's everyone collectively. No.
Yeah, that's
it's not everyone collectively. Right. It's you.
Because the earth is giving the chance to the wicked.
Right. Who created plastic, man? The fucking devil.
Why would you create something you can't destroy?
Right.
You got it recycled.
Who got all type of trash floating around the earth and shit, man?
Yeah, then you got people that try to do the thing of save the planet, earth shit. Look, the earth needs saving, but there's nothing that we can do to save it. What needs to happen is Yahweh Shai needs to return and a nuclear destruction.
Yeah,
that's right. The only thing that's going to save this planet.
Recycling and all that shit, that shit generated more money for the devil, man.
Yeah, I ain't doing shit.
You know, they try to mask it as something positive. Really, you're just a greedy bastard, man.
Nah, there was a documentary going to recycling. I'm not going to say it, man. I don't remember.
There was this Chief Gadite, they asked him what was in life before this devil came here, and he said it was paradise.
Shit, when Esau came over here, they say it's paradise.
Yeah.
They couldn't believe the things that Jake had going over here.
We got food every day. Yeah.
What they call it? Metro, I don't know what they call it, man. Like the cities on the water, you know? I don't know what they call it.
Oh.
But it was beautiful, man. You can just imagine. Metropolis, the water, man. Jake, this guy had Metropolis, man.
Yeah, they had the freeway, pretty much a waterway, freeway type of thing going on.
Yeah, bro, it's beautiful, man.
Also, that story of El Dorado.
Yeah.
That's probably based on some real shit, man.
Yeah.
The city made of gold.
Yeah, bro. Well, here come the devil, messed it all up.
He's like, only
now you gotta pay for water.
Wise tale, bro.
Now you gotta pay for water, man.
Yeah. Just being able to drink fresh water.
You know what that water gonna taste like, bro? Yeah, alkaline that water gonna be.
Right out the lake, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Instant energy.
Woo!
Instant kick. Drink it. Feel it rushing through your veins.
That's probably all you gonna need right there.
Yeah.
Just water.
It's gonna be gold flowing through it.
Right? Gonna have all the right minerals within it. How they, what they do to the water, what they call it, reverse osmosis.
Huh?
Reverse osmosis. They take everything out of it, right?
Yeah.
And they so-called put it back in?
Well, when we do it at the CNC, what they do is they raise the pH level. So they add salts, minerals, and stuff like that. And then they pretty much alkaline it into the right pH level, and it's perfect water.
I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, they do it with the washing cars, too. Leaves the water spots, everything. It takes out all the wrong minerals and use a salt and some other stuff, charcoal and all that. Yeah.
Devil gotta die. I can't wait, man. I just want to see what that looks like, man. The other side. So like even this is beautiful, you know.
I told my sister, I want to know what water really tastes like. She laughed at me. You don't know why I said that. Water ain't fucking, no, clean water tastes. Water we taste in eyes, the water is not supposed to taste like that.
Unless you go to Sweden or Switzerland.
Iceland. Like you got these water companies claiming they get their water from this mountain source. We don't know how true that is.
Yeah, what's that one? BG water. Yeah, right, man. Water ain't from BG.
Like Arrowhead.
Hell nah.
It's up the street from us.
Yeah.
So DeSoto, you know, they got a little water plate, they spill them up, you know what I mean? Barrels, like, just put your water.
They be like, put the mountains. No, it's not. It's not
you. You know what I'm saying?
Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1, it says, arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen up upon thee. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and the glory shall be seen upon thee.
Right now we're in gross darkness. People are in earth, gross darkness right now.
It says, and the Gentiles shall come to the light, and the kings to the brightness of thy rising. Lift up thine eyes round about, and see, all they gather themselves together, they come to thee. Thy son shall come from afar, and thy daughter shall be nursed at thy side. Then thou shalt see and flow together, and thine heart shall fear and be enlarged, because the abundance of the sea shall be converted unto the forces of the Gentiles, shall come unto thee.
The forces of the Gentiles, the riches of these other nations, man.
Yeah.
They're going to bring all their riches, all their power, all their substance. They're going to bring all that to us, man.
Rightfully so. Because the earth was very far sick.
Yeah, we're not going to have to pay overpriced for oil, for frankincense. No, we're going to get it.
We're not going to do any trading yet. Like the brother's saying, man, we're just going to receive it.
He had bought
it. It says, the multitude of the camels shall cover the dromedaries of Medan and the ephah all day from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and incense. They shall shoot forth the praises of the Lord. All the flocks of Kedar shall be gathered together unto thee. The rams of Nebaioth shall minister unto thee, and they shall come up with the acceptance of mine altar, and I will glorify the house of my glory.
Yes, they're going to accept the Lord. They're going to accept our ways, and they're going to follow all laws, statutes, and commandments. You know, they're going to follow our high holy days.
What's up, big bro?
They're gonna be under tributary to us. Y'all must be watching those movies where everybody brings something to the king. They bring a lot of daughters, they bring some cattle, they bring their finest utensils. That's how it's gonna go back to, man.
Queen of Sheba, she brought the riches to King Solomon.
She's out the door, man.
Verse 8, it says, who are these that fly as a cloud and as doves to their windows? Surely the isle shall wait for me, and the ships of Tarshish burst to bring thy sons from afar, and silver and their gold with them, unto the name of the Lord thy power, and to the Holy One of Israel, because he hath glorified thee.
That's what the brother's saying, tributary, and he will bring us their gold. Silver, you know, their women, you know, slaves.
Now they don't want the nations. The fathers don't want their daughters to be dating them.
Right, the king, hey, you know, be a concubine to take in the kingdom, man. That's gonna be a good life for the daughters.
Yeah.
So they're gonna want to do that, man. After this nuclear destruction, this place is so fun. This place is gonna be fucked up for a long time, man.
Even that's within the tribes too. Even the certain tribes don't want their daughters getting with certain tribes, you know? All that's gonna be stopped.
Yeah, all that shit's gonna be thrown out the window, man. We're gonna have our power back. We're gonna have the Lord with us. Alright?
It says, and the sons of the strangers shall build up thy walls, and their kings shall minister unto thee. For in my wrath I smote thee, but in my favor have I had mercy on thee.
And so the sons of strangers are going to build up thy walls. Just like we built up the walls for Edom on this side, man.
Is that the curse, though?
Yeah.
You will build, but we're not going to dwell in. Yeah. So these other nations, you're going to build, so we ain't going to dwell in. You know?
It said, therefore thy gates shall be opened.
You got to read that again, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Verse 10. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls, and their kings shall minister unto thee. For in my wrath I smote thee, but in my favor have I had mercy on thee.
All these kings, all these leaders of these different nations out here, and they're going to serve us. Your sons are going to build up our walls, they're going to build up our houses, they're going to plant our vineyards, all that, man.
They're all going to have mercy on us again, man. They ain't going to be angry with us, man.
Yeah, these heathens are going to be in that cool mind state. They don't want to please us.
I should say, you know, look at our authority, the people rejoice. You know?
Yeah.
The righteous are authority, the people rejoice. So even in their servitude, even when they're in their slavery, they're going to have it better than when they did when they was under Esau.
Yeah, because
it's going to be proper order. to worry about book breaking.
Ain't gonna have to worry about that woman.
Commit adultery and all
trying
that.
Trying to rule over her. I mean, you know, gonna have to curse on them, but, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna outlaw all that, you know?
Yeah.
Ain't gonna be no pork eating. We ain't gonna attack you through food. We're not gonna pollute the water, the air.
Yeah, we're not gonna initiate no prima nocta.
Yeah,
all that shit.
Ain't gonna be no abortions. You know, we're not gonna put no fucking metals in your mouth.
Yeah. Break your teeth, force you to eat shit.
I'm gonna break your teeth though.
Yeah. No, I'm saying like we're not teeth filling and stuff. Yeah.
No.
We're not gonna do the things that this devil does, man.
Yeah, you're not gonna be force fed pork.
We're not gonna lie to you and tell you there's something you're not.
Yeah.
You know? Ain't gonna be no more lies, man.
Nothing but truth.
Nothing but truth, man. Because that's against our law, right, lying? There won't be no lies. It's going to be pure reality, man. And they're going to appreciate that, man.
Yeah.
Everyone on earth going to appreciate the fact that everyone's going to be living in truth, man.
Right.
You know? Ain't going to be no more fat people either, man. Ain't no fast food. None of that shit.
GMO.
Yeah, ain't gonna be no GMOs, man. Ain't gonna be no preservatives, man, for the food. You know? We're gonna be able to eat real food, man. Real chicken.
Yeah. You're not gonna look at the back of the food and see a whole mess of the green,
right? Ain't gonna be no expiration dates, you know?
You gotta eat shit that you gotta look up what that chemical is.
Yeah.
Like
the water has that great thing, bro. Water, bro.
Yeah, hey, I have water in the house. Water I've been having it for like years. And I finally started drinking it. Shit, it tastes fire.
That's all that plastic seeping into it.
Yeah.
Which, whatever, man. What can you do?
EPA. Chemicals. So, back at Isaiah 60:11. Therefore, thy gates shall be open continually. They shall not be shut day nor night, that men may bring unto thee the forces of the Gentiles, and that their kings may be brought. There's always going to be something to do. Always going to be something to do.
Yeah.
The slavery is coming back, man. Continual employment.
Hey, we're going to always have something to do. It ain't going to be a born-ass world like this one, man. We're going to actually get to enjoy our wives, our children, you know? Our brothers, man.
Yeah.
We ain't going to have to leave our brothers, man. If we want to go and do something, go to another planet for 3 months, we're gonna be able to go to another planet for 3 months.
Yeah,
right? Imagine the stones that's on another planet.
Yeah.
We're gonna talk about stones, we're gonna be able to bring these stones back to the earth. Different animals, different sounds, different smells,
colors.
Different colors, man. Dang, man, what does that look like, man?
Animals, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
You know, Jake is innovative, they're gonna create different instruments, man. Even if you touch the ground, you ain't dirty, you gonna be good. You gonna be shiny.
Hey, in the ancient world, they wore sandals.
That's an ancient world.
Yeah.
Huh?
Go back like that. Living, riding horses.
Yeah. If you want to, you can ride chariots.
No, because the way that these shoes form, the toes supposed to be like this. Everyone's got their toes like this. You know, it's what you had, you know.
Yeah.
You gotta do things great, right?
Yeah.
We'll see, man. I like to say we'll see because it's like not certain, you know?
Yeah.
And it's like, it's feeding into hope, you know? You know, like we'll be there, you know? We'll see. I've been telling my seat that we'll see, man.
So verse 12, it says, for the nation and kingdom that will not serve thee shall perish. Yea, those nations shall be utterly wasted.
So those nations that choose not to serve, the Satan's gonna be on those nations. But most that they choose not to, they're gonna, you know, put it in.
Yeah, the Saints don't really work. Go mess down the nations.
Just like they had to beat that Christianity into them, that we're going to beat the truth into them, man.
Yeah. That's that 1,000-year period, though. 1,000 years to break through, man. Best believe we don't need 1,000.
Yeah.
We're going to be broken within that first whatever, you know? Once you see that power, you're going to submit.
Glory of Lebanon shall come unto thee, the fir tree, the pine tree, and the box together to beautify the place of my sanctuary.
It's all about trees, man.
Good, the trees, man.
Pine trees is beautiful, man.
Yeah.
And you have the Big Bear, a lot of pines.
Yeah. And you have some trees that just make certain areas look way better just because of the trees.
That's right here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they did that on purpose, bro.
Yeah, of course.
They know what they was doing with these trees.
Well, go to Compton. They ain't gonna be no trees.
And you know what looks dope? The like actual palm trees. Like you see, like the actual high ones.
Yeah.
Those
look
dope.
Yeah.
Going down the whole road.
Yep. Oh, we drive to the Bravo. I know you see it. That was nice. Right by the zoo. You see the zoo sign?
I'm going by the zoo.
No, it's on the freeway. It's on the freeway. See that one tree on the freeway in the middle. I don't know what it's called.
You got a picture?
Nah, I'm driving like a huge deal. I don't remember.
Next
that.
Time
if I go there.
Yeah, even the trees are gonna rejoice in that game, man. Gotta cut them down.
Yeah, but you guys said the roads, they have paved with these beautiful trees. In certain cities like Santa Rita, where they inspire themselves to be one of the richer cities, you got Stevenson Ranch on it. Every main street has a different color of a tree, like they blue. They're all white.
I never noticed that.
All orange. Oh, yeah. All the air. Ruhal Ranch, Bouquet, they all have either in the middle or the sides. The trees, they plant every year. They plant something new.
So it's like spring and summer, like when you can
see
it?
Yeah, in the wintertime, everything's really green. Most of the trees, they bloom, or their trees change the colors like the winter. So it's always, you know, seasonal.
Diala has ones with big ass leaves on them, man. So, yeah. If they have we're so used to seeing them small ones. They got big ones like that. Kind of, you know, think about that wall plants, man. Big ass stink plants, whatever.
Yeah.
We're going to get all of that, man.
Things going to be bigger in the kingdom, man.
Yep.
So back in Isaiah 16:14. It says, yeah, 14, it says, the sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending unto thee.
So these devils that we had to deal with on this side, man, they're going to come back and they're going to bend you down to us.
Yeah. Not looking us in our eyes. Made it, you know, slavery. Don't look me in the eye, boy. Something like that, you know. That's what they did. Well, you keep them heavy. Yeah. You're not going to have the right to look us in the eye.
They're not going to be able to speak English. They're going to speak that Hebrew, boy.
With your mouth until you can, bro.
Hey, King David said, people that I do not made obeisance unto me. Like, shit, yeah. Even come in your presence, they won't be in. Lord, like, Lord.
If he's a child, he says a child, and he didn't just start bowing.
That's what he's going to say. Okay, so like, I didn't finish 13. It says, the glory of Lebanon shall come unto thee, the fir tree, the pine tree, and the box together to beautify the place of my sanctuary. And I will make the place of my feet glorious. The sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come.
The place of his feet. Yeah. It's good to say, the earth is the Lord's footstool. The place of his feet, man. It's earth.
It's gonna be beautified, man. Once this was hit, man, that's that cleansing game. Alright, once this devil is out of power, man, that's it, man. Alright, the world is gonna be built up again. Alright.
Yeah,
all the nations are gonna build it.
Yeah.
Hey, read that part again where it says, Lord of Lebanon?
It says, the last, the whooping?
Yeah, what it says that part?
Yeah, it says, the glory of Lebanon shall come unto thee. It says the fir tree, the pine tree,
yeah,
and the box together to beautify the place of my sanctuary.
Yeah, like it goes into the trees, like the evergreen tree. They have the flag. If you look at the flag, that's the logo for Lebanon. But they're known for having some beautiful evergreen trees and other trees. They got the cedar tree.
All this stuff because the Lord gonna burn us, Israel, man. You know, we're gonna build from scratch.
We're not gonna build it, they're gonna build it. Yeah, the nation's gonna build it.
Yeah, like a finger. We're gonna be in our rest.
Yeah, kinda.
I'm gonna be chilling.
Yeah, chilling, you know.
Those trees, man, they're gonna make, you know, the country beautiful, man.
Yeah, trees are amazing, man.
You know, most I like it, the men are the trees.
Yeah.
Trees are very spiritual, man. Give off the sap, create incense, you know.
We ain't gonna have to build all this stuff and then leave it off to somebody. We're gonna live forever, man. We're gonna be able to actually see the transformation of everything, man. You know, we're gonna be here 300 years later, 400 years later, you know?
Something I enjoy.
Damn, bro, that means, you know, nobody, if none of us ain't gonna die, that means none of the spirits are not gonna be sent back up.
Not Israelite spirits.
We're gonna have to expand.
The earth is big, bro. The earth is huge, bro.
Oh, yeah, the earth can't contain all the spirits, and you gotta go out to the galaxy.
I mean, but the earth is huge, though.
Bro, yeah, look the same how, thing. It's like,
yeah, the earth is huge.
Yeah,
bro.
It is.
Bro, look how many
Israelites. There are other planets, though.
Man, look how many Israelites.
I don't think we're gonna have to go to other planets for that reason. We're just gonna go to other planets.
That's our recreation.
Yeah. I can't over 8 billion people on Earth, bro. You know, the Most High is perfect, bro.
Yeah, that's true.
You can't overpopulate this Earth. There is no such thing. I mean, I guess now you can.
gonna be trillions of Jake something.
Yeah, yeah, bro, that's what I'm saying.
But hey, the Lord might give each brother his own plan, you know?
Yeah.
And he didn't say you will, bro. Many
matches, man.
It's forever growing, right? Like a curtain.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Stretching my thing. Yeah. For a reason, right? But I want to enjoy Earth, man. I want to see what's going on. You know what I mean?
Thy children shall make haste, thy destroyers and they that made thee waste shall go forth of thee. Lift up thine eyes round about, and behold, all these gather themselves together and come to thee as I live, saith the Lord. Thou shalt surely clothe thee with them all as with ornaments, and bind them on thee as a bride doeth. For thy waste and thy desolate places in the land of thy destruction, which is referring to the land of Israel, shall even now be too narrow by reason of the inhabitants, and they that swallow thee up shall be far away. That the children which thou shalt have after thou hast lost the other shall say again in thy ears, the place is too straight for me. Give me place that I may dwell. When you read that in the NLT, well, I'll read one more verse. Then shalt thou say in thy heart, who have begotten me these, seeing I have lost my children, and am desolate and captive, and removing to and fro, who have brought up these? Behold, I was left alone with these, where had they been? Now, in the NLT, verse 19, it says, of Isaiah 49, even the most desolate parts of your abandoned land will soon be crowded with your people. Your enemies who enslaved you will be far away. The generations born in exile will return and say, we need more room. It is crowded here.
Wow.
Then you'll think to yourselves, who has given me all these descendants? For most of my children were killed, and the rest were carried away into exile. I was left here all alone. Where did these people come from who bear these children, who raised them for me? Because, hey, in Isaiah, in the same chapter, scrolling down, well, I'll continue, 22, because I'm just there. Thus saith the Lord God, behold, I will lift up my hand to the Gentiles and set up standards to the people, and they shall bring thy sons in their arms, and thy daughters shall be carried upon their shoulders. And kings shall be thy nursing fathers, and their queens thy nursing mothers. They shall bow down to thee with their face toward the earth, and lick up the dust of thy feet. Lick up the dust of thy feet, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord, and they shall not be ashamed that wait for me. Right, man, because he's going to be too proud for Jake. All Israelites that look like these other nations are scattered, you're going to have these nations that are going to bring them to our land. Like, you're an Israelite. This is where you belong. You know, you have all Israelites. Remember, Isaiah 60 says that one is going to be like a small nation.
Yep. That's what we got, right?
Right. So, we're going to be not just living in the land of Israel, but we're going to be inhabiting all the earth except America. Right. America is the only place that will not be inhabited. Okay? We won't. Hey, you got Lebanese Island, Russia, China. Well, of course, the names are going to be changed. Yeah. But even in Antarctica, you know, the Lord's preserving that place for a reason. But wherever we want, man, because Jake's going to have to you know, live off, you know, other parts of the earth. But eventually, Jake's gonna be going into the to the galaxies, man. All right.
Living in South America.
Right.
Yeah.
Bro, I know we gotta go back to Jerusalem for the facade. Because all of us gonna fit in the land.
I think it's.
What did you say?
We'll see.
Brother,
we'll see.
Prophesy part. You know, part.
That thought came to me as well. But hey, we'll see, man.
Hey, man, the earth is bigger than what we think, man.
Yeah.
The earth is big, man. It's bigger than Esau tells us, man. It's the center of the universe. I mean, come on, man.
Same thing with these continents.
Hey,
sir, continents are smaller than they appear. In South America, Africa, way bigger than they appear on the map. America's smaller than that, you know?
Yeah. That was a good pitch, that, man.
Yeah, come on.
You shut me up with that one.
It's all through the spirit. Probably how much you want to shout.
It's going to really be a full house.
See, that's why, bro, why I have the new Testament. I mean the NLT. Yeah. On the side, while I was reading on my phone.
Yeah.
Now, what does this mean? Oh, makes sense.
That's good. When you gotta have an NLT open when you're studying. When you're reading, man, got to. I mean, it's just good to have. But go ahead.
But I can keep it the facade. It'll be a new hot over there, right?
Yeah, it will be a Passover. We'll keep the Passover. It'll be a Passover of remembrance of deliverance from America. Not Egypt.
And right. We might keep all the holy days, though, because we still try to keep all the holy days here,
man. Watch this guy, man. Go ahead.
Right. It's Isaiah 60:14. It says, the sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending unto thee, and all they that despise thee shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet.
Yeah, so people are going to come bowing down.
Hey, finally the heathens are gonna know their place in this world, man. When we get back up on top, go with them when we fit. The heathens are finally gonna know their place, their rightful place in the earth, and their servants to us.
Yeah. It's gonna be made known when the Yahweh Shai returns and they see, you know, who he is, man. Alright? It says, and they shall call thee the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. Where, verse 15, where areas thou hast been forsaken and hated, so that no man went through thee, I will make thee an eternal excellency, a joy of many generations.
Yeah, we'll get that position back, man.
Yeah.
Top nation on the planet. All the nations are going to see that. They're going to understand it. They're going to come bowing down.
People are going to see that, hey, you know, we are the Lord's people, man. You know, finally, hey, our power is going to be with us.
Right.
I never leave us.
Our people are going to be normal again, too.
Yeah.
These fucking weirdos out here, man.
There ain't going to be no curses. We're not going to look, you know, our eye isn't going to be evil against our own brother, man. You know, and there's going to be nothing but love. It says, where areas that has been forsaken and hated, so that, you already read that. It says, verse 16, thou shalt also suck the milk of the Gentiles, thou shalt suck the breast of kings, and thou shalt know that I, the Lord, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, am the Savior and thy Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob.
Mighty One of Jacob, back to Israel, you know, all about Israel.
It says, for brass I will bring gold, and for iron I will bring silver, and for wood brass, and the stones iron. I will also make thy officers peace, and then thine exactors righteousness. Violence shall no more be heard in thy land, wasting nor destruction within thy borders, but thou shalt call thy walls salvation and the gates of praise.
That's right, no more wars, no more violence, man. We shall learn of war no more. Only violence is gonna be on these other nations that can't act right.
Yeah, right. Right.
You know, shit, that first thousand, they ain't getting their shit busted in.
Yeah.
For sure.
It says, verse 19, it says, the sun shall be no more thy light by day, neither for brightness shall the moon give light unto thee, but the Lord shall be unto thee an everlasting light, and thy power, thy glory.
That's right, going back to Revelation 21, going back to Jeremiah 31, we're going to be perfect. We're going to have all that wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Yehovah shall shine. The sun, I say it again, the sun is always going to shine.
The moon
is always going to shine. Seasons, daytime, nighttime, ordinances.
Yeah.
You know, let's talk about the wisdom of our people. We're going to be a people of wisdom.
There's going to be no need to like have a sit down, a class, to show our people the ordinances anymore. Like it says in Jeremiah, man, it's going to be in us. It says, thy people also shall be all righteous. They shall inherit the land forever.
Verse 20.
Oh, I skipped the verse. My bad. It's verse 20. It says, the sun shall no more go down, neither shall the moon withdraw itself. For the Lord shall be thine everlasting light, and the days of thy mourning shall be ended.
We're going to have that light continually, man. That spirit continually.
And it says, the days of that mourning shall be ended, man. You know, like it says in Revelation, man, you know, he's coming to wipe away all tears, man. There's going to be no more death, man. Our people, they're going to live forever. All right? It says, thy people also shall be all righteous. They shall inherit the land forever. The branch of my planting, the work of my hands, that I may be glorified. And this it says, a little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in this time.
And that's the growing of our nation, man. A little one shall become a thousand, man. Your kids, kids, kids. It's going to be a whole nation, man. Thousands of kids, man. Thousands of ancestors.
The first thing I didn't want to do is hit for him.
And like brothers were saying earlier, man, if you wanted it, man, you could have a whole planet just full of your seeds, man.
That's right.
All right?
And we ain't gonna be like Esau, oh, wait till she's 18. No, man, as soon as the woman develops, you know, when she get that, you know, she's right, she gonna be married to him. She gonna be given to a righteous man.
Yeah, they're gonna be mature with it too. They're gonna be mature by the age of 12, 13, they're gonna be mature.
Yeah,
flower of age, you know, when a woman has a menstrual cycle, you know, that's when she becomes a woman. According to scriptures, that's when you can marry a woman at that age, when she has her first menstrual cycle. But you don't do that shit now.
Yeah, just
don't deal with no underage girls out.
Yeah, just for clarity, in the kingdom, fellas.
Yeah, man. I mean, a 12-year-old girl now, you know, she's a little-ass girl.
Yeah.
But in the kingdom, it ain't gonna be like that. It won't be like a 20-year-old woman now, you know, mature woman. Cook, clean, all of that.
Yeah, man, the kingdom is something to look forward to. That's just a beautiful thing, man. We just read scriptures about how the streets will be paved with gold. We're going to build up our kingdom. The nation's going to build up our kingdom. Precious stones, sapphires, rubies, you know. But before that, you know, it's a time of trouble that we have, that we're going to have to go through. All right?
Yeah,
the kingdom ain't there just yet. All right? Let me get a...
They ain't got fucking niggas, man.
Yeah.
Looking for trouble and shit.
Get that Jeremiah 50 and 33. And then we can jump to 2 Ezra 15 and 1.
It's book of Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 33. It says, thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah were oppressed together.
Children of Judah, there it is today. You know, Israel again. Israel, northern kingdom, southern kingdom, were oppressed together. We all were slaves. We all had to deal with this hell. We're continuing to deal with it. That time is over, so.
And all that took them captive, held them fast. They refused to let them go. Their Redeemer is strong. The Lord of hosts is his name. He shall thoroughly plead their cause, that he may give rest to the land and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon.
Yeah, disquiet. Waiting on that rest right now, the Lord's about to disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon, the Babylon the Great. this time right now. You know, look at that word disquiet, because right now everybody's quiet.
I'm getting it. Okay. What is it, Jeremiah 50?
Yeah, it's
50 and 34. Disquiet. Right now, everybody's quiet, everybody's at rest, everybody's at peace. As soon as they say peace, they say peace, sudden destruction is going upon them. Everybody's out on Saturday driving around. But soon, most of the time, it's going to disquiet these people out there.
Tremble, quake, rage, quiver, be agitated.
Quiver, quake, rage, be agitated. Throw up your whole agitated spirit out here, man. Real soon, man. During this time of Jacob's trouble.
Be excited, to be perturbed, to quit, to be disquieted, be excited, be perturbed. You know, that's the basic game.
Yes, you know.
To enrage, to excite oneself.
Enrage. You know, most high is going to pull a rageful spirit out here at this time, man. Let's jump to that 2nd Edmunds 15. Everybody's got something.
You got the military testing. Simulation on blackouts. You have Esau stimulating what to do for the next pandemic. You got all these stuff happening, man. So, 2nd Esdras chapter 15, verse 1, and it says, behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy.
That's what we're doing every week, man. We're speaking out the ears of prophecy.
I'm not sure.
Soon there's going to be, you know, a famine of the word. We're not going to get this truth.
I'm not sure.
Right?
It says, which I will put in thy mouth, said the Lord.
He will run out, blow ye a trumpet in Zion. You know? Blow the trumpet, man. Truth being put in our mouths. We're spitting it out to you right now. Right? Yeah.
And cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true.
Not one of these shall fail. You know? Not one of these scriptures shall fail. They are faithful and true, all right?
Fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee.
Yeah, so we don't, we call up these scoffers out here, the unbelief of these people out here. Just talk about what's going to happen to the sinners, man. The ones that refuse to be sinners. The ones that don't want to be sinners. The ones that don't care. The ones that refuse to repent. They're going to get caught up in that lake of fire, man.
That's right.
They're going to get caught up in destruction, man.
That's right.
Take the law, take a struggle, an hour of temptation, you're going to take that chip. And ultimately, you're going to die, all
right? That's right.
You're going to get caught up in that second death.
It says, for all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness.
All the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. You got a whole lot of people out here that don't have faith, man, that don't want to believe, man.
Right.
They don't even have a counter faith.
Yeah. Hand joining hand, the wicked shall not go punished.
Esau might say we extreme because we say if you don't believe in this word, you're going to die. Well, the scripture says all the unfaithful shall die in your unfaithfulness.
Yeah, it's not our words.
It's the Lord's words. It says,
hey, don't kill the messenger, you know?
That's what you're going to do. There's going to be some martyrs out here, right?
I don't
you're going to kill the messenger. That's all right. Just part of Yahshua's plan.
It is what it is, man. They hated not their lives unto death.
It says verse 5.
Hey, hey, we ain't got nothing here anyway.
Yeah,
we
got shit lines here.
What we got? You know?
It says, behold, said the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, and death, the destruction of Slavia.
Right, plagues upon the world, sword, famine, and death.
And destruction. That's right.
That's a blow right there, man.
That don't sound like nothing good, man.
Nothing good, man. Well, it's the beginning of sorrows, man. Right now, we're at the beginning of sorrows, man.
Right now, they just found a new variant over there in Europe. You know, that C. It says there's a new variant. And then you got something out here killing people called a fungus.
That's the Marburg virus.
Yeah.
Yeah. Pestilence, yep. Yeah. Wars, rumors, wars. Got that uprising in Sudan right now.
Non-stop earthquakes.
Hey, while people ain't paying attention, the plagues is fighting people right now. Taking their lives.
Forget about the people that took that juicy juice. People dying. Catching all kinds of health problems.
I got two co-workers. I noticed the other day, we were driving a shuttle there. And one lady, we noticed that she got the twitch. She's driving, she got twitch on her. She took the jab, right? And she had failed to bust her eye and all that. But then it's the other Asian guy, he's driving, he's doing the same twitch.
Oh.
So I was like, oh, y'all must have the same batch.
They got the
hold up. Yeah, over here. I was like, oh, you through too, man. I was going to piss.
No, I seen this TikTok video or short on YouTube. Yeah. Well, it's a short on YouTube. And the woman said, why do people, tripping off and pulling up to a handicapped parking spot with no sign? And then she got out of the car and she was like, you know that juice messed up her legs.
They were driving close, man. Took that pestilence, man.
Not seeing the unfaithful of our people, man. You know? They didn't have faith in y'all about me outside. They took that juice, you know?
It says, the wickedness has exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled.
Yeah, man, we're seeing that right now. I guess it passed through law where these kids, the parents have no say whether the kids can have sex changes or not. The parents have no say in that now. It's out here in California, man. Looking at this as exceedingly, exceedingly polluted the whole earth. You know, it's a wicked society that we're in, man.
The most wicked, bro.
How can you get a permission give a kid permission to change his sex and chop his rod off? He doesn't know what the hell he's doing. His mind hasn't even fully developed yet. How are you going to give him the power to make that decision at that age and tell the parents that they can't do shit about it?
And it's good to say that foolishness is bound in the heart of children. So our children don't know nothing, man.
They don't know shit.
What the hell does a child know? You know, their brain's not even developed right. Look at this shit.
Look at that shit. You want to watch just the way you are.
Come on, man. You gotta get out of here, man.
They totally want to destroy masculinity out here, man. They totally want to destroy manhood out here, man. This place has gotta go,
man. It's a goddamn circus, man.
Help put the dudes in dresses. We just saw a billboard and advertising for some drag queen show that's coming out.
Yeah, that's the same motherfucker that was talking to kids about drag queen shit. Is that kid a doggy a drag queen? The little kid was asking that question. Like,
you gotta be crazy to have a kid in this society, man.
No, why would you even want your kid to be around shit like that?
I know I'm just saying though, people look at me, you know, 40-year-old man, no kids, look at me like look at me sideways, I'm crazy. Look at you like you're crazy. You're gonna raise a kid in this society, man. I get to hear the truth.
Yeah.
The most high looking out for me. These two-third motherfuckers having kids, it's crazy.
Hey, like, you as a parent, you can do your best to raise your kid, right? But there's so many shit in the world I can influence to do the opposite of the way you raise them.
Especially the older they get, bro.
Yeah.
The older they get, the more you gotta keep them from shit.
They don't even understand, like, why can't they be on this, why can't they do that?
See, but that's why you gotta tell them young, man. You gotta get to them young. So when they grow up, they can be able to judge things.
Yes. That's why Lord told us to spread out the rod. You know, that's why we gotta discipline them. If I had children, I'd just get out of
there. Train them up the way they should go.
Micah 2:10, it says, arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest.
Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest. How do you rise and depart from this place?
by taking heed to the word thereof.
That's right.
You and your mind.
I read in Romans 12, man, we're not conformed to this world, man. We understand how evil, how wicked it is, man.
It's blatant now, bro.
Yeah.
When we came in the truth, it wasn't as blatant as it is now.
Yeah.
They kind of hid the wickedness. Now it's just fucking wickedness. Come and join the party, man. They ain't got no shame, nothing.
Hey, the other problem when you speak against it.
Yeah.
Here it is. The man is looking at sideways, and he has multiple wives. But this weird thing, this alphabet thing, no one looks at that sideways.
Or no one looks at a woman having multiple men side of
it. Yeah, right?
Yeah. It's poly, but it's poly with a woman having multiple men.
I mean, that shit upside down. A new show was Brother Husbands.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Got a new show, Brother Husbands.
All happy.
What the?
And then, she got 200 men already?
And you know what she told those dudes? She told them, I'm thinking about getting another one.
The dude was looking at her like,
it's a new show?
Yeah.
What's up?
Yeah.
Huh?
Brother sent out in the chat, yeah.
Oh, yeah. See that?
Brother?
No, brother.
Crazy. N-dubs are leaving it, bro.
I can see that.
You heard of that show on Sister Wives? About the dude out there in Utah, he's got multiple wives. Basically, spit off of that. So, brother husbands. Now they flipped it. The women got a bunch of husbands.
Was the Sister Wives with Jake or Edom?
No,
see how they do? You see how they do it? But when it's the other way around, they got the nigga woman there, man.
Hey, there was this one show, I forgot what it was. We had these two couples, they're all dating each other. Two female couples, one female, one male each. They're all dating. You have the female dating her boyfriend, but she was dating the other guys, the other boyfriend, and boyfriend was dating his. Like, it's all confusing.
That's right.
Then they all had kids. They had kids amongst each other.
This place got to go.
It's like,
you said brother what?
Brother husband. Seeking brother husband. Brother husband. They and each other.
That shit was straight up weird, man. You got one guy petting the other guy. Like you're a father and brother. Shit.
Nah, man. It's crazy, man.
Yeah. What the hell?
I mean, that shit is off, man. You can't have multiple men with one woman. But you're not going to know the paternity of the kid.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the main reason you can't do that shit. You can be one man with many wives, and there's no question of who the father is. When you flip it, you don't know who the dad is with that shit.
This is the one?
Yeah, that's it.
Let's go home.
I ain't gonna watch this shit. It's hard for me to watch shit, bro.
I'm just fucking with you, bro.
Like, even with the NBA shit that you let me watch on YouTube and TV, I gotta mute the commercials, bro. Every time I go to commercial, I mute that shit, bro.
Shit's on a commercial, bro.
I just mute that shit, bro, man.
I just watch another game. Or the commercial, I go back to the game.
Oh, see, I didn't know about that. I'm gonna do that. I mean, I only give a fuck.
I mean, there has to be two games playing at the same time.
I only care about the Warriors, bro. I like watching the Celtics, bro. The Celtics, everybody's dope as fuck with the Celtics, bro. Everybody.
Yeah,
I can see them taking the whole thing.
We're winning this year.
Yeah, I can see them taking it, brother. Watch. Everyone is dope, bro.
Nah, bro. LeBron gonna get it. This is LeBron show.
The
NBA LeBron show.
You didn't know? I mean, if you want to do it like,
I don't even like LeBron.
But when it comes down to talent, it's either the Warriors or the Celtics, bro.
Back to Micah 2:10. It says, arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest. Because it is polluted, it shall destroy you, even with a sword destruction.
Yeah, our people are destroyed, man, for a lack of knowledge.
Yeah.
You know, they're polluted, man.
They can't understand that, you know, we're being attacked as a people. The brother said masculinity is being attacked, man. They don't want leaders, man. They don't want independent thinkers, man. Alright? Hey, like it says in 2nd Ezra 16, man, they're here to destroy those that fear the Lord, man.
Yeah.
Alright? That's who they're targeting.
Let's skip to say, who shall go down, or who shall stand up, basically? Let me see. Yep.
Oh, okay. Against the workers of iniquity?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a new commercial. I've been watching Hulu. You know the one where you get to the commercials? They always show this commercial of Jake with HIV.
Bro,
and it's Moe's, bro. Just pure Jake Moe's on that shit, bro. And then and the last seat is a it.
What?
Is it it?
What is it, bro? Say what it is.
Transformer.
Oh man. Just say a fucking a tranny, bro.
I'm trying to talk like a woman and shit.
That's it. I never heard that one. It. What the fuck? It.
That in itself is an attack on our people. Alright? Like putting us front and center, you know, those commercials, man, you know, hey, that's being the accuser of our brethren as well, man.
Yep, I got Psalms 94:16.
No, it's
who will rise up for me against the evildoers? Or who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity, man? So we're standing up against all this wickedness, against all this evil, man. Somebody gotta do it. Through the mercy of Yahweh Shemoshai, man. And we against it, man. You know, and Esau eventually gonna come for us, man. Eventually.
Yeah. Even 7,000 men, you know, that bowed down their knees to God, man.
But it is what it is. What we gonna back down?
Yeah.
You know, hell nah, man. Fuck that. Alright? We stand up for righteousness. We stand up for Yahweh Shemoshai, man. We stand up for our people, man. Alright? We don't fear you, goddamn Edomites, man. Fuck you, Edomites. Fuck your world. And fuck your mark, man. Fuck your threats. Okay? Hey, if the Lord be for us, who could be against us, man? There are more with us than are with you, man. Straight up.
Matthew 10:28. It says, and fear not them which kill the body.
That's right, man.
But are not able to kill the soul.
And that's Yahweh Shai telling us that.
Yep.
He said, don't even fear these cats, man. That can kill the body. All they can do is touch you.
Yeah.
But what Yahweh Shai can do is far greater than that, man. That's what we fear, man.
They can only touch you if the Most High even allows
it. If he allows it, bro.
Yeah. Yeah.
If he allows it, man.
And that's what Yahweh Shai told Pilate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And who's to say the Lord gonna allow it? Who's to say the Lord can't give you spiritual power in that moment, man? I don't give a fuck about you goddamn devils, man.
That's right.
This shit gotta stop, man. It has to stop. And it's gonna stop in a violent way, man. We're gonna have to go toe-to-toe. The righteous versus the wicked, man. Let's go.
That's right. If you touch it because the Lord wanted it, man.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's a trial of your faith. You know? But like you said, bro, it's gonna be martyrs.
Yeah.
That's that. Hey, that's some men are gonna be beheaded, man.
That's prophecy.
That's prophecy, man. You know, some of us gonna end up in camps. The Lord said that, Revelation 2:10. So hey, no matter where how it unfolds, it's all prophecy, man. But some men gonna get power.
Yeah. That's prophecy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Some men, hey, some men ain't nothing gonna happen to, man.
Left hand power won't help you against the men that get power.
Yeah, man. To lift up the standard.
That's right.
Yeah, whatever you got brewing, you know, exoskeletons, man, different guns, whatever weapons you're forming, man, it's not going to do nothing to the Lord's men.
We're going to be like Black Adam, man.
Yeah.
That shit. Hey. Man, that opened. When they rose up Black Adam, that shit was hot, yo.
Yeah.
Man. He's gonna raise up men, man.
I was like, that's why.
Hey, I wish I said there shall be something that shall not take death.
There's no fucking.
Yep.
Only right because of mine. So that goes to show you that some of us are not gonna die, even if we do get apprehended.
Bro, who's the Lord gonna beat him up?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The Lord coming back to beat some up, man.
Yeah.
Somebody gotta be here.
Yeah.
You know?
Big fathership.
Yep.
Brother's gonna fill up that ship, man.
Yeah. Right, in Revelation 11, I think it is, it says a cloud, it's singular.
Yeah,
one cloud, yeah, man, one chariot, man.
He says somebody got to get beamed up.
Somebody, bro.
There's going to be a bunch of brothers getting beamed martyrs out
there. Because the ones that are martyrs, they're going to come back with the Lord.
Yeah.
They're already going to be up there.
The Lord is coming to showcase his power, man. You know, it's written how the most feeble among you are going to be as King David,
bro.
All right, that's all to magnify the Lord, man. The weakest one of us, man, is going to be like King David.
Man,
yeah.
And King David had power, bro.
Yeah.
King David was a mighty man, man.
That's it was 10,000, man.
Yeah, you got busy, bro.
Yeah.
Hey, King David was beamed up to a ship, you know?
Yeah. He says, "And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell."
So that's what we fear. Get us to Rock 1 in 8.
Hey, you saw, he wants us to tremble and beg for mercy, you know? The way he's coming, he wants us to tremble and beg for mercy like he's done.
Two-thirds do that.
Hey, you know what scene that reminds me of? Emancipation, when the dude was like, beg, beg.
I remember it.
Yeah, remember? Dude was about to kill him, huh?
Oh, okay, when he got caught, when they were running away.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Tracy, yeah.
And he got caught, he was like, beg.
I don't remember that.
He wanted Jake to fear him, but Jake didn't fear him.
Will Smith?
Yeah. You remember that part? Where the other Jake's team is
that's
in?
What the last, yeah, that's the
yeah,
last.
Yeah, it's like the ending of it,
Oh, you're talking about, when they shot him?
Yeah. He saw was getting him to, like, he wanted him to tremble in fear and beg for
him. Yeah, fuck you devils, man. Hey, the Lord didn't give us the spirit of fear, man. You know, we ain't supposed to yield to you. We ain't supposed to listen to you all because we're afraid to lose this life. Nah, man. We know what happens after we pass from this flesh. But do you? You're the one that's wicked. You should be afraid to die, not us.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 1, verse 8. This is, "There is one wise and greatly to be feared, the Lord sitting upon his throne."
There you go. That's right. What we fear.
Yeah.
The Creator.
St. Andrews, chapter 15, verse 7. "Therefore, saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness, which they profanely commit, neither will I suffer them in those things."
The Lord ain't holding his tongue no more. You see that now. As prophets out here, condemning this place, condemning the two-thirds, man. Condemning America.
That's right.
Prophesying to God.
"In which they wickedly exercise themselves, behold, the innocent and righteous blood cries unto me, and the souls of the just complain continually. And therefore, said the Lord, I will surely avenge them, and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them."
Yeah, a true avenger, man. Your house shy, man. You're going to avenge, you know, the elect.
It says in Zephaniah to wait until he comes.
I rise up to the brink.
"The whole of my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I would not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt."
That's a dude.
"But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm, and smite Egypt with plagues as before, and will destroy all the land thereof."
Yeah, the Lord's going to strike Egypt, aka America, like the plagues before, man. Like the ancient Egypt plagues, man. All that's going back on this time. Instead of the two-thirds being delivered, man, they're going to die right here.
That's right, man.
Two-thirds ain't going to be up in the chairs, man. Fuck them.
Yeah, what does Skip say? Revelation, let the righteous be right still, but let the unjust be unjust. Forget about Jake, man. Let him die, man.
I got to close precepts. Hey,
but
you know, hey, it's another Saturday down, man.
Close. Another day closer, man. Yeah, it's just enduring. All praises to Yahweh, 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 Yahwe
Shalom.